Welcome, Pirate fans, to the Berg pregame show in honor of the Duke, Rob Willard, and Mean Gene Willoughby with your color man, Tommy Tebow.
Thank you and welcome, Pirate fans. And I am also joined by the one, the only, Boston Brent.
I'm a god.
Boston Brent. Have a god. Ha, ha, have a god. Ha, ha, have a god.
All right, guys. Tonight's contest, the Wheelersburg Pirates and the Waverly Tigers, all on bergfan.com. Our JV game. Congratulations to our young JV squad. 45-33 victory. That moves them to 2-0 overall and 2-0 in conference play. Special thank you to all of our sponsors, which includes Deemer's Market, the C Store, Caudle Trailer Sales, Glockner's, Schmidt's Family Restaurants, Dempsey's Heating and Air, Ridge Mini Mart, Misty's Cone Shop and Johnson's Shirt Stop. And a special thank you to Mr. Bo Arnett, Waverly's Athletic Director, for hosting us tonight, and the radio folks next to us for being so pleasant. Boston Brent, Tommy Tebow with you. What's to come throughout the broadcast, Tommy Tebow?
All right, Boston Brent. Well, we're going to look at in the pregame show, we're going to look at Ruck Daddy's keys to the game. And also a fan favorite, Bill May's score prediction segment, and we got a surprise predictor in that one.
We also will have Scott Verba's mascot trivia challenge. Get your Google app ready. That'll probably happen in the first quarter. Our very own version of Would You Rather with Tommy Tebow. You nervous, Tommy?
I'm a little nervous.
Well, you should be, because I wrote them. Quick six.
And probably the most favorite segment of last game is, and we'll bring it back every game because there's plenty of them.
We will
have our brand new Steve Sutton story of the game, and it's guaranteed to be worth it.
At halftime, we will have our first half analysis with the stats from the truth, Dusty Salyers, and Bruce Moore's official rating segment. And during our post-game segment, we'll have stats from, again, your pal Dusty, the truth Salyers, game recap, some reflective thoughts, and some game analysis, along with your Ruck Daddy's player or players of the game, hopefully some possible interviews, and then again, our thoughts moving forward in the upcoming week in Berg basketball, as well as what's next for Berg Fan Podcast for the rest of the week.
All right, and just some house cleaning items. We have a new shout-out number. All right, I repeat, we have a new shout-out number.
Get your phone ready.
We will try to repeat this throughout the broadcast, but please use this one for basketball season. It's a dedicated one for the Berg Fan Basketball Podcast. It is 740-580-2036. I repeat, 740-580-2036. Send text messages to the shout-out line and get a hold of us. Give us some shout-outs. Shout-out right now to Bryson Keeney.
And to
state champ. And Alex George, state champ.
And to the officials. I guarantee you just came back from a smoke break. Guarantee it, knowing who the officials are today. It's going to be a great night. Stay tuned throughout. Now on to our pregame thoughts. First up, the Pirates bold from Wheelersburg, Tommy Tebow. Oh, wait a minute. We've got to back up. You have a bowl challenge that you want to hit.
I do. We have some pregame entertainment brought to you by Johnson Shirt Stop. This pregame entertainment is a bowl name challenge.
So
here's how it works, Boston Brent. I'm going to give you a bowl name, and you have to tell me either real or fake.
Do I have to do it in a Boston accent?
Yes, you do.
Boston accent, real or fake, real or fake, real or phony.
All right. And
I'm going to say phony.
I'm going to keep your score here, too.
Okay.
We'll see how many you get right.
I haven't looked any bowl games up.
No, you have not. Real or fake? All right, first one, the Raycom Media Bowl.
That's real.
That is correct. The Auto Nation Cure Bowl.
That is real.
That is real. The Dallas Credit Union Bowl.
That's phony.
You're on a roll.
Oh, yes.
3-3. The Camping World Stadium Bowl.
That's phony.
That is real.
No.
That is real.
The Caudle Camping Trail. Oh, okay. Go ahead. I'm ready.
The Cherry Bundy Tart Cherry Boca Raton Bowl.
real. That is real.
Yes!
Game on.
The Papa John Peyton Manning Bowl.
That's got to be real.
That's
no,
fake.
No.
You already went real. That's fake. Peyton Manning don't have no bowl yet.
That's true, but he owns some Papa John's.
The Bad Boy Mowers Gasparilla Bowl.
Oh, that is true. That's real.
That's real.
Yes.
And the Gildan New Mexico Bowl.
Oh, that's real.
That's real. And I know that's real because our very own Keaton Newsom was a part of that bowl game with the Marshall Thundering Herd. So shout out to Keaton. Marshall Thundering Herd take home the win. Congrats, Keaton. Keep up the hard work. Keep making us proud.
What's my score?
You did very well. You went, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 correct, 2 wrong.
That's 75%. That's good for Boston, Brent.
That's pretty good.
I'll take it.
Pretty good.
Now, let's take a little closer look to our scouting report sponsored by the C-Store. We're going to start with Tommy Tebow and the Berg.
All right.
The Berg.
The Pirates, 1-0 early in the season with a good road win over Northwest Mohawks, winning 67-59. Now, that one started with the Pirates' big run, got ahead in the third quarter. Mohawks were able to climb back in it. Pirates faced some adversity in that game but was able to come out with the win. The Pirates had 4 in double figures with Connor Mullins, J.J. Truitt, Tanner Holden, and Cole Lowry. Cole had 25 points and 9 rebounds, and Tanner had 13 points and 20 rebounds. Count them.
Ridiculous.
20 rebounds.
And the nastiest two-hand flush I've seen since the Celtics lost to the Lakers in 82.
It was epic. All right, offensively, it's going to be hard to tell where the offense is going to go, considering against Northwest they face some junk defenses. They face the box and one. They face the triangle and two. But they will probably have to face that a lot this year, Boston Brent, with Tanner being such a dynamic player and also Cole picking up a lot of the scoring there also. All right, however, talking with Coach Ader, they will be a dribble drive-oriented team. The Pirates do look to run, especially when Holden and Lowry grab the rebound. They are very athletic and I think will be a good perimeter shooting team, especially when Trent the Mayor Sayers returns from injury.
The Bears. Defensively, the Pirates will pick some full court, 2-2-1, three-quarter court press, mainly a half-court man team that prides themselves on keeping the ball out of the paint, forcing contested jump shots, and kind of a more pack-line defensive look, focusing on gap control, containing the dribble and whatnot. The Pirates are a very good rebounding team, especially with Holden, obviously 20 rebounds last week, Dyer, Sayers, and Lowry. The players. Oh, hold on. We got a quick
photo op.
We got a photo op. The players. The Pirates go about 7-8 deep. Main scorers are Holden and Lowry. They're really the two that kind of make the engine run. They're the gasoline. The Berg had a great crew of role players. Mullins is pretty good this year, obviously. I think he'll have a good year. Truitt, Justin Sayers, Mac Dyer, and then providing kind of a defensive presence, Dustin Darnell.
Yeah, and hopefully that depth will get even better when we have Trent come back and also Ashton Clevenger sideline right now with injury.
And that's kind of a look at your Wheelersburg Pirates. Go, Berg, go. We will be back with the Waverly Tigers scouting report in a moment.
Just a good old boy, never meaning no harm. Beats all you never saw. Been in trouble with the law since the day they was born. Straightening the curves, yeah. Flattening the hills. Someday the mountain might get up, but the law never will. Making their way. That's just a little bit more than the law will allow.
All right, we are back. Gotta love a little Waylon Jennings. On the Waverly Tigers scouting report, 5-1 on this early season, 3-1 in the SOC. They did lose to Oak Hill by double digits, but that's no that's definitely the best team or one of the best teams in the league. They have wins over Miami Trace, Northwest, South Webster, West, and Valley. Defensively, man, run, and jump full court team. They love to trap, create bunches of turnovers, lots of pressure, play aggressive in a half court man. One thing about Coach Robertson's team is they love to get deflections and really kind of that spurs their offense. Biggest thing is they want to create chaos, helter-skelter, if you will. Waverly wants to steal it, deflect it, rebound it, and go. Tell me a little bit about Waverly's offense.
All right, offensively, they're up-tempo, fast-break team, love the pressure and push, which that's what we've seen for a number of years from them under Coach Robertson. They typically run a lot of sets or quick hitters with flare screens, back doors, lob plays, and they're very athletic and able to do that. And they're very quick, and they tend to shoot it quick, and they really do not want to work to score in the quarter court, so they want to run. So we got to slow them down there. Their main offense here is 4-out-1-in with lots of screen-aways. Mainly, though, they love to run and shoot and then shoot a lot of threes, especially in transition. A
couple key players for the Waverly Tigers. Number 23, Easton Wolf, kind of 6'4 kid, long, athletic, pretty good in transition, kind of an inside-out threat. Number 12, Ethan Adrian, big, physical post that rebounds it well. Shot blocker, will also shoot the three. Number 5, Cody Remington. They also have another guard, not sure of his name. I think it's Marquez. They put a ton of pressure on the ball. Our ball handlers are going to be tested tonight.
Marquez was a good wide receiver in football, very quick.
I mean, we're going to have to handle their pressure in the backcourt for sure. And then they're probably their best and most prolific scorer, number 0, Clayton Howe. He was a quarterback on the football team. Really, really good shooter. Must find him quickly. They love to run a lot of sets for him off OBs, side OBs. They always have. And biggest thing is you've got to find him early in transition and lock him down. You've got to be focused when you guard Clayton Howe. I'm hoping we don't mention his name a whole lot because that's a good thing for us.
All right, Boston Brent. Well, you've laid it all out there. That's your scouting report. That's a very in-depth scouting report. Now, tell me, what's the keys to the game for the Berg to take the win?
Number 1, no doubt about it, transition defense. Find shooters early, often. Got to do a little bit better job than we did against Northwest in terms of closing out on shooters, making them come off a circle, make them work. I tell you what, this Waverly squad has never been real patient. And in terms of getting the ball reversed a couple times, they want to shoot it quick. So we got to find them early. And then I also think the most paramount thing in this game, because of their athletic ability defensively, is we got to gang rebound. Our guards have to do a good job rebounding tonight, in my opinion. Holden will get 15, 10, whatever rebounds. Our guards have got to get in the act. How about offensively, Tommy Tebow?
All right, we have got to take care of the ball versus their attacking style defense, especially when we sub. Our subs going to have to be able to handle the ball because this is not a game where five can play the whole time. And the first half against Northwest the other night, we only had 4 turnovers, which is great. But Northwest is not the attacking defense.
No, they play zone.
Yeah, that Waverly is. So we have got to do a good job of that. We need to get to their bench by attacking the rim and making them foul. They're undisciplined after a short amount of time, so it can be fundamentally sound shot fakes, pass fakes, strong with the ball is going to help us.
I like that. That's a good one.
And I truly believe Holden Lowry and a third contributor in the scoring column will be key, like they did versus Northwest. Holden Lowry have to play well in this one.
All right. It's going to be a great one. I tell you what, this reminds me of the Celtics, the Lakers, back in the 80s. And I'm not talking about Kyrie and this ball boy. I'm talking about Magic, Bird. I'm talking about Worthy. McHale, I'm talking on the parquet floor. I'm talking Yastrzemski. I'm talking Red Sox. I'm talking all of that. Now, the Ruck Daddy keys to the game coming straight from you from Widener Road. Number 1 from Ruck Daddy, hydrate. Hydrate. Got to have high-quality H2O.
It's clean. It's cold. And that's what I call high-quality H2O.
They also have to have a good, stable amount of hair gel. Brought to you by Bryson Williams.
None other than Bryson Williams. Number 3, don't get distracted by Coach Robinson's orange shoes or his muscle shirts. I'm looking right now. There's a little bit of orange in his shoes. Definitely he's got the muscle shirt going, though. What's number 4?
He's looking pretty buff these days.
Well, you know, he's been in the weight room. He's been doing that stuff.
All right, and the 4th one, and probably the most important one, is don't trip over the ball boys in warm-ups.
That's you're going to hurt an ankle. That's what's going to happen.
And they're everywhere.
That's brought to you by Dimas. You want chicken? Stay local. It's greasy, but it's worth it. When we come back, it'll be the Phil May prediction segment right before tip-off.
Speed ball back.
And we are back right before the starting lineup. Correction. Coach Robertson does not have orange shoes on. He has some gray, looks like some patent alligator skin is what I'm looking at. What do you think about them? They're like pale gray over there.
Hey, he can pull it off.
All right, so the Bill May game prediction brought to you by Ridge Mini Mart. Scott May. All right, TK, what's your prediction for tonight?
All right.
I'm writing it.
I'm going with 74-73 Bird.
1 point.
A 1 point game, high scoring. I think this is going to be an outstanding game. Both teams just competing, battling back and forth, and that's coming out on top.
All right, I like it. Boston Brent is going to go with Berg, Duberg, 63, Waverly, 59. 4 point victory for the Pirates. Ruck Daddy. Ruck Daddy gave a prediction today. This is the first time Ruck Daddy's ever gave a prediction. Berg, 107. Waverly, 1.9. Yes, that's actually what I said.
All right.
Wheelersburg, 107. Waverly, 1.9.
That'll be hard to do. Duberg.
What's Bill May's prediction?
All
I got
to
know.
We have a guest predictor, and that's none other than Bill May.
Bill May.
So I call Bill May just like I'm going to do every game and get his prediction. And Bill May says it's going to be 50-30.
50. I love it, Bill May. 50-30. That's fantastic. What's our shout-out number again? Let's remind everybody.
All right. That shout-out number is...
Let's find it.
740-580-2036. That's 740-580-2036.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Right now the Tigers from Waverly are being announced. They got lights out. They got all these daggone strobe lights going. You know what that means? Nothing. Nothing to the Parquet group. Nothing. Right now, the Pirates are in this dark black unis. I like them. I like them.
Oh, yeah. Look sharp.
I tell you what. And then the Tigers are in the white unis. Looks like we've got 0-5. Who the heck is starting? It's hard to see in this place.
Well, it's dark.
It is dark. It's 47 times darker than it was last night. All right. So we're about ready to get started here, folks. Hopefully we can be a little bit more serious. We're going to try at least. Don't forget your first quarter segment, Scott Verba's Mascot Trivia Challenge, brought to you by Cottle Trailer Sales at Woofer's Landing Campground. If you win, you're going to win a free two-night stay over there, maybe a free admission to the Cottle Trailer Sale. What do you think of that? That's a pretty good gift.
Yeah, I heard they got a nude beach over there.
Well, I can't ever say that. I've never been there. So, and I'm not going.
Todd Ruby. It's under new management. Todd Ruby
under new management. All right, for the tip, again, starters, Mullins, number 12, 15, Dyer, 21, Lowry, 22, Truitt, 23, Holden. For Waverly, 0, Howe, 1, Marquez, 5, Remington, 12, Adrian, and 23, Wolf. And here's your tip. Goes to the Pirates. Cole Lowry on the right wing, setting the O. Remington guarding tight. Ball's trying to flip to Mullins. Mullins guarded by Howe. Truitt pulls up for three. Good! And boom goes the dynamite. 3-0 Pirates. Waverly quickly
boom,
down the floor.
Shakalaka.
Over to number one Marquez on the left wing. Looks like you're getting in a stack set. Waiting on that stack to help. They're going to go back door, I bet, right here. That's what they always do.
They like
this.
To go back door.
ISO looking to dump it in the post.
Yeah, yeah.
It's number 12. Adrian misses the shot. Rebounded by Holden. Outletted quick to Lowry. Lowry going quick. Just kind of fumbles it a little bit. Kicks it up to Mullins. Mullins hits a backdoor cutter to Holden. Holden goes up. Schoen finishes. Good start for the Pirates. 5-0.
I think Waverly saw that Willisburg was playing behind the post against Northwest, and their first possession looked to attack the post.
Absolutely. Howe closely guarded by Dyer. Dyer doing a good job keeping him off the circle. Ball's dead over on the left wing by number 23, Wolf. Reversed over to Howe. Back to Wolf again.
Pirates playing with a lot of energy
already.
I like
this. Marquez on top now. Wolf driving it. Goes baseline. Finishes. 5-2. 6:40 on the clock in the first quarter. Pressuring. Foul on Marquez.
Silly foul by Marquez.
Absolutely. 98 feet from the basket. The floor is 92. That's not right. 91.
Yeah.
91 feet. Waverly Tigers in full court pressure right now. Gives it up to Lowry. Looking at that run and jump trap right now. Guarded closely by Remington. Skip now over to Lowry. Here comes the double. Good job by Lowry or by Holden giving it up. Lowry backing down Remington, going up tough. Gets it stripped. It's pretty quick hands, like we said in the scouting report. Remington going in fast break. Goes up for a layup and gets it. 5-4. 6:15 in the first. Ball's inbounded to Lowry. Up quickly. Over to Dyer for three. No good. Long. Rebounded by Mullins. Good offensive rebound right there. There's a kid in my way I can't see. Truitt drives it. Looks to walk. Yep.
Yep.
He traveled. Too many steps.
Dandelions are the devil.
I tell you what, I don't think Waverly's transition defense is very good at all. Once you get past that first wave, it's wide open. We just kind of fumbled the ball a couple times. Six minutes.
We have got the look to push, which early we are.
I like our energy where we're at right now, though. On their floor, looking to push. Up to Howe on the top of the key. Looks to travel, but no call. Hands it off.
Oh, he traveled.
Number 23, Wolf.
You got Mullins deep.
Shot up, rebounded by Dyer. Out quickly.
Two on one.
Pulls up from a little. Nope. Off the glass, no good. Rebounded by Adrian. Up quickly to Marquez. It's like a track meet.
I think we're going to get those shots if we want them all
Look
night.
At that. What a great job right there closing out by Dyer. Backdoor cut by Wolf. He fouls. Holden fouled him in one. Well, maybe one. But that bucket's good.
Yeah, that bucket's good.
That was a good backdoor cut. We kind of stared right there. They go backdoor. Holden fouls him on the arm. 6'5" Waverly. 5:23 on the clock. First quarter.
We got the father-son duo, two of the officials tonight.
That's true. Free throws up, no good. Rebounded by Holden. Holden up the timeline. Crosses over. Goes behind the back. Gets it stripped by Remington. Remington bringing it back down the floor. Goes up against two guys. Travels. No call. But rebounded by Holden. Holden brings it up
three
quickly.
Three guys standing there looking at Tanner. We got to push.
Holden for three. No good. Long. Rebounded by Truitt. Go up strong, big fella. Off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Mullins. Good offensive rebound. Looks to fade away.
Yeah.
Short. He should go up strong. Rebounded by Adrian. Back down the floor quick. Howe for three. Gets it tipped.
Go back. Run back.
Lowry. Up the floor. 3-on-2 break. Dunk it, baby. Dunk it! Sir dunks a lot!
Boom shakalaka! Boom shakalaka!
That's what I'm talking about!
Boom shakalaka!
The second dunk on the season. Two-handed flush. 2-on-1 break. Good pass by Lowry. Drives it back down the floor. Marquez and good.
Another and one.
Kind of hit him in the head when he went to the rack.
Yeah.
8-7 Waverly. 4:27 on the clock. I'm running out of breath.
I think the players are, too. I've seen, like, three Waverly players fall down in transition.
I tell you what, how about the 2-on-1, drops it off, and he doesn't even have a step to catch it and still goes up and hammers it.
Yeah, made it look easy.
First free throw's up and good. Three-point play is good by Marquez. 9-7 Waverly, 4:30 on the clock, first quarter. Holden bringing up the timeline. He shoves off.
That's two on Tanner.
That is not good for the Pirates.
No.
Oh, no. They caught. Oh.
Oh.
They caught a block.
Okay. Okay.
Good call. Tanner. That's a fantastic call.
Tanner does got to be careful, though, about that offhand. They're going to be looking for that now.
Wow. Robertson's having to be detained. There's a sheriff over there about ready to cuff him.
He might change his shoes at halftime.
He might. I tell you what. The light gray is not. I don't like the light gray. No. I like the bright orange.
Yeah. I mean, you always know where he is when he has the bright orange on.
Timeout, Robertson, and that timeout is oh, no. It's either a timeout or a technical. Which one is it?
I think it's a timeout to yell at the referee. Nope, nothing.
Nothing. Just a whistle blow and a point. All right, inbounded to Truitt. Back at the action. Holden on the right wing. Looking to set the offense. Skips it over to Lowry. Lowry looking inside. Nothing there. Back on top to Mullins. Looking for the backdoor cut to Holden. Holden goes up strong, gets fouled. It looks like it might be on the floor. This is going to be a chippy one.
Well, I think we're going to see this a lot this year. I just think with Tanner, like kind of last year we talked about his body language and letting things get into his head, which he done great last game on that. But teams are going to try to get in his head, no doubt about it.
Shout out to the backdoor. Shout out to Carl Minford. Ask how long the court is. Sorry, I was wrong. It's 92 feet. By the way, that wasn't on the floor. They called it in the act of shooting. It'll be free throws.
And that shout-out's in reference to the year that Minford did a new football field, but didn't quite make it long enough.
First free throw up. Looks good. Holden kept that head still, nice and quiet with his lower body. I liked it. 4:08 remaining in the first, 9-8. Waverly's up one. Second free throw. Holden takes a couple dribbles, a little deep breath, good bend to the knee. And good. Nothing but cash.
The loop spin a rooski.
9-9. 4 minutes. Over across the timeline. to Adrian. Adrian goes in strong. They call blocking foul on Truitt. That was a makeup call.
Yes, because, I mean, that's just one where he's being aggressive and the defender's just standing there. And I mean,
but I don't blame him.
I know. That's one they're going to call every time, but I just hate that.
I do too. The defense has no right to space, apparently. Inbounded to Remington on the right wing. Up top to Howe. Again, there's a set. He doesn't have it, but he gives it up to Adrian inside. Adrian misses, gets the offensive rebound. Back to Remington. He gets hacked, and they call it. Looks like that might be on number 15, Dyer. That'd be two shots. 3:51 on the clock. 9-9. Tie ball game right now. Tie ball game.
Once again, text our shout-out line. That is 740-580-2036. Text us.
First free throw's up and no good. I love that Harvard yard. Harvard yard. Ha, ha, Harvard yard. That was good. That was good. You are a tech genius. That reminded me of Robert Parrish's up and under move. Or is that Kevin McHale? That would be Kevin. Second free throw up and good. 10-9, Tigers.
It reminded me of Larry Bird's mustache.
Subbing in the game is number 30 for the Tigers.
That is Dunn.
What is Ethan's size? How big is Ethan?
Ethan is 6'4", junior.
6'4", junior. All right, now to the game is Adrian. Inbounded to Truitt. Truitt up across the timeline quickly to Lowry. Lowry drives baseline, shoves off, no call. Skipped over to Mullins. Mullins takes it to the rack. Gets it grabbed and stolen by Remington. Remington, 3-on-2 break. Gives it up to Howe. Wants to shoot the three. Holden, good job closing out. Inside to Remington with the right hand and good.
Pirates have not subbed yet.
Timeout. Wheelersburg, we will be back with your Scott Burba trivia question. 12-9, Waverly, 3:29 on the clock. Your Scott Verba mascot trivia challenge brought to you by Cottle Trailer Sales from Wolfwood's Landing. Don't forget the shout-out number, which I can't remember, but you can.
740-580-2036.
Here's your question. Who is the mascot for the University of California, Santa Cruz? Again, University of California, Santa Cruz. Who's their mascot?
And congrats to our last game's winner, Lainey Greenhill. I heard she went and got her chicken dinner.
I like
Said it was greasy, but worth it.
But worth it. Stay local. Truitt across the timeline, drives it in. Gets it stolen away.
That's got to be a bounce pass.
By Dunn. Dunn across the timeline. 3-on-2 break. Takes it in. Kicks it back out to Howe. Howe for three. No good. Rebounded by
nobody.
Well, tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with the go with the Pirates.
Waverly still looking to
who
extend
do you
their
think
pressure.
The University of Santa Cruz mascot is?
Well,
the
I don't
Bobcats?
Think it'd be fair for me to answer because I got the answer right in front of me.
Oh, you do. Lowry across the timeline. Drives it in. Tight, goes up strong, and they call a charge. It's kind of forced right there. They had three guys in the paint.
Yeah, he could have kicked it there, inside out three.
And that's exactly what Coach Hader just said. Two-foot stop, kick it out. 12-9, I could read his lips.
Yeah,
Three minutes to go.
If we're going to look to play some dribble drive, that's the looks we got to get. Mm-hmm. Dribble to the middle, kick. Because we're going to have shooters.
Your leading scorers are going to take some bad shots. That's just normal.
Yep.
Just don't take 10 of them. Remington, across the timeline, or 47.
We have a guess on the trivia challenge by
illegal
Jonathan
screen.
Eaton.
Yes.
Sammy the Slug. I'm sorry, Jonathan, that is incorrect.
But you are close.
You are close. And that could be – Sammy could be his first name, but
– It could be.
But it's not their mascot.
He obviously has Google.
Yeah.
That was an illegal screen by the Tigers.
You know who the best Google person in the world is? Chad May.
Lainey Greenhill?
No, Chad May. Mr. Google.
So Pirates cross the timeline quickly. Lowry makes the two-foot stop this time, just doesn't miss it, misses it off the glass. Remington down quick. He travels, and they call it. Good call.
And see, Cole, I think it's going to be important for Cole all year to get going early. He's the type, if he's going to come out and miss some shots, he's got he'll let his frustrations get the best of him. So I think Coach Jader sees that, and talking to him right now, got to get his level head.
I tell you what, though, he can play, man. He can really play. And he also had over 1,000 yards in football, so that tells you enough.
Yes.
Holden getting bumped up the floor. No call. Holden looking to pass it over to Truitt. Truitt for a deep three.
No
good. Off the front iron. Rebounded by Howe. 12-9 Tigers. Up quickly to Adrian. Adrian for three. No good long. We got numbers. Holden got the rebound. Bringing it down quick. And they got bumped. I tell you, he would have finished. Guaranteed. They weren't going to stop him.
I tell you what. Tanner is smooth. Running down the floor and
he's
on the
as
breaks.
Smooth as the other side of the pillow.
Smooth as butter.
Well, last year I remember this young man checking in. Jake Reed, number 20 for the Tigers. He's the henchman.
Now, speaking of subs, we still have not subbed yet.
We haven't subbed. But I think that's – we kind of knew that going in. It was going to be a tight ball game.
Yep.
Number 20 is the physical. He's on Holden, and he's bumping him right now. What did I tell you?
He's holding him.
I remember him last time. His job is just to go in there and make people miserable and bump them and foul them, and they're not calling it. Lowry drives it in. Let the floater. Good. Got to love to see that. 12-11. 2 minutes. Balls out of bounds. Goes back to the Pirates. Little turnover. Little careless error for the Tigers.
The loop-de-loop spinarooski.
Timeout. Tigers, don't forget.
30-second timeout.
Oh, 30. All right, so let's go back to the let me talk to you a little bit about the Scott Verba mascot challenge. So last year, during the Super Bowl, Scott Verba told me he knew every mascot known to man.
Oh.
We have a winner.
We got a winner. We got a winner.
So at Mike Skiver's party barn, we're watching the Super Bowl, and I quizzed Verba on 330 mascots. No joke. 330. And guess how many he missed?
How many?
Zero.
Wow.
He missed none. Matter of fact, he told us the last trivia question at Delta State University. He said, I was there last summer.
Yeah.
They're the statesmen. You got it wrong.
Yeah.
But all right, so who's the winner?
All right, our winner is Andy Saltzman with the correct answer of the banana slugs.
The banana slug. Now, since you're a teacher, what's a banana slug?
A banana slug is a slug that looks like a banana.
That's not true. Oh. It's a bright yellow, slimy shellfish mollusk commonly found in the redwood forest. That's what it is.
All right, so Andy, you win free two-night stay at Wolford's Landing and free admission to the Cotto Trailer Sales.
Enjoy.
Now, Andy, you better not sneak off that nude beach. I'll tell Jess.
Andy, don't forget, you get free admission. I mean, what gets any better than that? Free admission to Cotto's Trailer Sales.
All right, back to action here. What up? We got a little hold up here with the ref.
It's definitely the Pirate basketball.
Yeah, I don't know what the discussion is.
Look at number – I mean, he's a kid. He's been telling what to do, but look, he's right in his face. Number 20, right in Holden's face, trying to make his life miserable. If they don't call it, though, not much we can do. Just play through it. And the Waverly student section doing a great mockery job. Inbounded to Lowry. I like that out-of-bounds play. On top to Lowry. Lowry looking to dribble drive. Kicks it over to Truitt. Truitt shot fake. Drives it. Steps through. Little 15-footer and good.
Boom shakalaka.
13-12. Wheelersburg. 1:39 on the clock. Up quickly to number two, Hoover. Number two, Hoover drives the baseline. Gives it up to Adrian in the paint. Off the glass. No good. Holden skies for it. Good outlet to Mullins. Running deep. Mullins with the left. Good off the backboard. The kiss. 122, 15-12 Pirates going on a little 6-0 run here. Number 30 just traveled. They didn't call it. Good. Steal by Dyer. Dyer.
He tries up.
Up quick again. Dyer going in tight. Little runner and a block. Two shots. Mac Dyer. Great job by Mac Dyer. Help him recover. Steals it. Takes it coast to coast. Two free throws.
You know, I think this is very similar to what we've seen against Northwest is that early in the game we're able to go on that run. Now the question will remain as long as we can keep Waverly from the big run. Obviously, Coach Barrick always used to say basketball is a game of runs.
That's absolutely true. We got some subs coming in, so we're going to take the last minute, try to get a little breather for a couple guys.
We got Dustin Darnell coming in the game for Cole Lowry, and Justin Sire is going to come in for the shooter, Mac Dyer, on the make.
Yep, 1:10 on the clock, 15-12. Right now, Holden's got to be very, very smart and not pick up that second foul. Second free throw up and good by Dyer. Justin Sires, man crush, 14 coming in. I love Justin Sires. Have I ever said that
to you?
Did you
buy him a Christmas present? You should.
I don't know.
You probably should buy him one.
Well, he's got good hair. He's got Bryson Williams hair. Remington, across the timeline. Up to Reed. Reed drives it and skips it. to number 30, Dunn. Dunn goes in off his leg, but off Darnell's leg, goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Tigers. 1 minute on the clock, 16-12. Pirates looking to inbound it, going a little 1-4 low with a little stack action on the ball side. Kicks it out to number 12, Adrian. Adrian gives it to Reed, looking to hit Hoover off a double on the weak side. Nothing there. Good job by the Pirates connecting on that, not letting getting loose. I like we're switching screens a little bit. Remington takes it off the bounce and scores.
Straight line drive. I hear Coach Spradlin behind us saying the same thing. We can't give a straight line to the basket like that.
Holden across the timeline, goes in hard, gets hacked, and they call it a charge on that?
That's a makeup call from earlier.
What I tell you, though, that's his second foul. Man, 38 seconds on the clock, 16-14, Pirates.
I know you hate talking about officials, but I do feel like officials in this area just let the momentum of the game and the crowds make too many daggone calls.
I saw this many times. When you got a good player, I mean, you still got to call fouls. I mean, just because they're good doesn't mean they don't get fouled.
Right.
Darnell doing a good job on Remington up top. Looking for the back door cut. Not there. That's a little set. He just traveled, but no call. Back on top to Hoover. 20 seconds on the clock. 16-14 Pirates. 15 seconds. Darnell getting after him on top. Sires, guard number 30. Dunn on the left wing. Remington driving it. Good crossover. Kicks it out to Hoover for three. No good. Rebounded by Sires. Four.
Chinnett,
three.
Strong.
Two. Oh, no. Just hold it. And they call foul.
Mental mistake there by Justin.
Got a rebound. Just hold it with a couple seconds. Yep. Instead, he tries to outlet it. They steal it, and he fouls. So there'll be two free throws with no time on the clock.
And that was one of our keys to the game, is the subs to be able to come in and handle the pressure. That's, and right there we did not.
So here we got number 30 done. Got the steal and got fouled. First free throw's up in, no good. Doesn't hurt us yet. Second free throw upcoming. And it is up and good. That'll be 16-15, Pirates after one. We'll be back.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
And we're back, Pirate fans. Little Johnny Cash, I fell into a ring of fire. All right, right now, a couple stats for you that's going to be important as this game moves on. Holden's got two fouls. For us, Howell, their number one leading scorer, has got two fouls. And then Marquez, their really good on-ball defender, has two fouls. So this second quarter is going to be critical, Tommy Tebow, to make sure nobody picks up their third. Hopefully Waverly does. We don't.
Yeah, definitely. I'm hoping they're Lowry will get a little break at the end of the first. Hopefully he can come back, have a spurt us on a run here. We're going to need his scoring, especially with Tanner out.
I think this next two-minute segment's huge. Right now on the floor, we got Truitt, Dyer, Justin Sires, Dustin Darnell, and Cole Lowry. For Waverly, Hoover, Remington, Reed, who's number – Adrian, and then number 30, Ethan Dunn. So both groups have some subs in, so we'll see what happens. Looks like Hoover's going to come off a double right here. Looking for the lob, not there. Good defense by the Pirates. Good defense by the Pirates. Turnover, Tigers.
The referee's talking to the fam.
I guess so. 16-15,
we got Pirates. We got the rowdy crew, Chad May, Chad Johnson, Jared Tilly over there giving the ref an earful.
They're scared of May's beard.
Yeah.
Tigers in a 2-3 zone now.
And I saw they wear a hat to cover up his bald spot this game.
Lowry from about 40 feet. Misses the three.
Oh, yep, that's a good call.
Dyer,
that's a good call.
With the shove off.
He extended the arm. Anytime they see the extend on the arm on the back, they're going to call that. Good call.
But it wasn't quite 40. Probably 26, maybe.
47, maybe?
47. 7:37 in the second quarter. Wheelersburg up 16-15. Shout out to Bryson Williams Hair, best hair ever grown west of the Cider River and east of Manchester. Hashtag it's a weave.
Hashtag or a shout out to us. Rob Wheeler just says we're fired.
Well, but we got your stuff.
That's
so
true.
What is he going to do?
Yeah, I mean,
he's at the C store. He's not going. He can't come here. First free throw because they're in a bonus is up and good by Adrian. So that means the Pirates will be in the bonus next foul as well. So it's going to be a foul shooting contest the rest of this half. Second free throw up and good. Tigers up 17-16 over the Pirates. 7:37 in the second quarter.
Cole's taking over point guard responsibilities with Tanner out.
Right now, again, the Tigers in a 2-3. A little flare screen for Lowry.
He shuffled.
They didn't call it. Skipped over to Mullins. Mullins reverses field to Darnell. Then back over to Lowry. Lowry crossover. Skips it over to Darnell to the right wing. Connor Mullins for three. Good! And boom goes the dynamite.
Boom shakalaka. Boom shakalaka.
I like it. 19-17. Pirates, 7 minutes, second quarter. Versus field to Ethan Dunn. Now to Remington on the right wing, looking to go into post.
Truett guarding the post.
Good help side right there by Darnell. Skipped over to Reed. Reed puts it on the deck. Takes
charge.
It in. And they run him over.
Yeah.
What a charge. That's what I'm talking about, JJ.
Hey, and this is something that a lot of people don't see. He won't get credit for it, but Dustin Darnell, great help side defense initially. Made us reverse it to a guy that didn't want the ball. Leads to a charge. Great job, Dustin.
I love the sacrifice. There is nothing better in a game of basketball than a charge. I love it. And I love the fact that our kids got excited. The coaching staff got excited. The world gets excited when someone takes a charge.
I feel like you like charges.
I love them. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Charge.
What was the best charge you ever took?
I don't know. I took a lot of them.
You did?
Yes. I love taking charges. Lowry inbounding it. Talks across the timeline against Remington. Now Waverly going back man-to-man. They didn't like that zone. Lowry with the little floater. Off the glass. No good. Rebound. It goes back up. Off the glass. No good.
Cole just a little off.
Rebounded by He'll number 23, going. Wolf. Back down the rim. Truett, good help right there. Taps it. Goes out of bounds.
19-17, Wheelersburg. 6:37 to go here in a second.
Same set as before. Got a stack on ball side and then kind of a 1-4 low set on the weak side. I guarantee you they're looking to get it back to the inbounder right here. What'd I tell you? Back to the inbounder.
Yep.
And then Cole Lowry steals it.
Look up.
Good scouting report. Cole Lowry pushing. 3-on-1 break. Gives it up to Darnell. Off the glass and good. 21-17. Great fast break. Tigers back down the floor. Truett takes a charge. That'd be two of them.
Loop-de-loop spinnerooski.
Truett, two charges. Your stat of the night so far.
I tell you what, you got Dustin Darnell coming in, sparking this team, comes down, gets a layup, and then at the other end we get a charge by Truett. Great job, Pirates.
I said this two-minute segment was critical. Their subs versus our subs, and we're making a run.
And our subs are winning.
That's right. No,
uh-oh.
Get your head up. Turnover.
We spoke too soon.
Stolen by Wolf. Back down to Florida Remington. Yep. He gets fouled, misses the shot. He'll have two free throws. All right, well, I'll knock on wood next time.
Yep. So Cole was bringing it up. He threw it to Justin. Justin was just running down the floor, wasn't looking for the ball. Hits Justin. Waverly leads to the fast break and foul on Truett for Waverly.
And that is the second foul on Truett now. So right now the Pirates are still doing okay with holding on the bench. Remington will shoot the first of two, and he will get it. 6:14 on the clock.
Here comes Tanner into the game.
I like it.
They're going to look to probably play him some offense defense when they can. Get him out when we're on defense. Get him back in when we're on offense.
Yep. Truett out, holding in. Truett's got two, but he's taking two charges. I love charges. JJ Truett might be I might be a fan now. I love people that take charges. Second free throw up and good. 21-19 Pirates, 6:14 on the clock. Holden bringing it across the timeline versus pressure from Wolf. Remington doubles and steals it and finishes. 21-21, 6:05 on the clock.
See, Chad May can never take a charge. He was too short. They just jumped over him.
I love Lowry's little shake. Darnell for three, no good. Rebounded by Dunn. Across the timeline versus pressure. And gives it up to Remington, and he carries it.
All right, we're going to have to weather this storm here. We had a turnover. I think Dustin was feeling the energy on offense. He tried his hand out of three there, no good. But hey, we're gonna take that from those guys.
That's a prime example of what Waverly wants you to do there. They want you to shoot it fast and play fast.
Yep.
So we got to be a little more disciplined.
Play out of your comfort zone is what they want.
Holden inbounded.
Cole
going against Remington. Excuse me, Cole inbounded. Going against Remington, he does a good job against his pressure.
Cole pushed
off. Up for 15. No good. Again, shooting it quick. Sire skies for the rebound. To Mullins for three. No good off the back iron. Again, rebounded by Lowry, but stripped away from Remington. Remington going back down the floor and throws it away. Stolen by Mullins. Back down the floor. Track meet continues. And now we're going to slow it down.
Smart with so many guys in foul trouble like Tanner.
Tie ball game. 5 minutes on the clock, 21-21. Connor Mullins with the ball on the top of the key gets it to Holden at the half-court line.
Once again, give us a shout-out, 740-580-2036. New shout-out number for basketball season this year. Write it down. Put it in your phone, 580-2036.
Lowry with the Jody Ellswick pull-up, and good, 23-21, deflected out of bounds by Mullins. Good D. We're doing a much, 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 much better job guarding the shooters tonight than we did Friday night.
Yes.
You can definitely see two practices showing a difference.
Yep.
Their best scorer, Howe, now subbing in for Dunn, 23-21.
And that's going to be so fun with this group is to see how much they grow in just short amount of time, exponentially,
like
just from each practice because they haven't hardly had any.
Oh, we're in a little 2-3 zone. And the ball's off Howe, but they keep it with the Tigers.
Which I like going to the 2-3 zone for one. It confuses Waverly. They're not ready for this. And two, it protects Tanner a little bit from getting his third foul.
And that's exactly why they're probably running it. This guy in front of me that officiates is a fantastic gentleman, but smokes too much, and he knows it. Kicks out to number 12, then a fake handoff, and then giving up top.
Shout out to Rob Wolf. Woodward's Wranglers.
I love that, the Wrangler. Off the glass, no good by Howe. Rebounded by Holden. Holden bringing it across the timeline. Going against two, against three. Little shuffle cut. Ball's on the floor. Stolen by the Tigers. Back on. Oh, again, stolen. I don't even know what's going on. It's slap, slap, slap. Back over to Wolf. Wolf's got the ball. Kicks it up to Howe. Howe against pressure. This is getting chippy. I like it. Over to number 12. Shoots a little baseline jumper. No good. Rebounded, but he's out of bounds. Going back.
Cole's got to go up and grab that. He doesn't allow that guy to go over his back.
With the Pirates. Right now is key. I really believe this four-minute segment is key. 4 minutes, 23-21 Pirates. Cole Lowry does a great job against his pressure. He's so shifty.
The great teams like the Duke Blue Devils, they in halves. That last 4 minutes, they into half.
That's exactly right. On top to Holden.
23-21 Pirates.
Pirates going a little dribble drive. Skips it over to Lowry for three. Good!
Boom,
Cash.
Shakalaka.
Softest Boom, church music.
Boom, shakalaka.
Tigers up the floor going against the trap. Lowry with the steal. Darnell.
Facing.
Lowry. Darnell fakes it. Goes up strong. Gets fouled.
26-21 Pirates. Darnell to go to the line for two.
Dustin Darnell, the heart and soul, in my opinion, consummate team player. You know, he comes in, he does his job. He's already got 2 points. He gets a little steal there, goes coast to coast. He's got two free throws.
And I'm telling you, when you come and watch the Pirates play, and Dustin R's done this game, watch him play defense. He does a great job.
First free throw's up and good. Attaboy, Dustin. Attaboy.
We got a shout-out from the captain, Rob Woodward.
The captain.
We got a Greer Fox shout-out to Truett for the two charges.
I like it,
Good
Greer.
Call, Greer Fox.
Second free throw's up and no good. Tigers back across. Got a shout out to my boy Lane and Ella. Excuse me, Lane, my boy, Ella, my girl, Chamberlain. Tigers into the corner with Howe. Howe looking inside, nothing there. Again, Pirates staying in a 2-3 zone. 3:13 on the clock. Pirates up six. Howe for three. That's too easy. Too easy. And it's good.
Dandelions are the devil.
27-24. Lowry has the ball against pressure. He is so shifty. I love it. Lowry takes it out.
He pushed
shoves off.
Off,
and yep. They called it. Yep.
He did that earlier, and they didn't call it. Yep. He finally got caught. But a lot of our guys are doing that against this pressure. We got to be careful with that going in the second half.
Now, Lowry has two fouls. So we got Dyer, Lowry, Holden, Truett, all with two fouls.
So basically what you're saying is the refs are calling a lot of fouls.
Well, I mean, it is kind of a – I mean, honestly, I think the refs, and I hate to say this because Bruce Moore is going to hurt me, but it's adequate. It's very adequate. right now. That's what my
you
rating would be.
Love officials.
27-24, 2:50 on the clock, still going against that 2-3. Howe on the baseline, stolen by Holden. 2-on-2 break. Holden smartly brings it out. Kicks it up to Darnell. Darnell skips to Justin Salyers. Gets it stripped away. Stolen by Adrian. Adrian down the floor. Darnell
fouls.
He
pushed. He pushed a little bit.
Oh, whoa, whoa.
He threw the
ball. Whoa.
Here's my question, though, for you. Is how somebody that once made a player guard a referee during the game loves officials so much now.
I'll tell that story at halftime. So Holden, by the way, the whoa, whoa, whoa. Holden goes up and blocks a shot after the foul, and Adrian just takes the ball and throws it at him, and they call no technical. First free throw up and good, 27-25 Pirates, 2:33 on the clock. I've never spoken this much in two quarters in my life. This thing is going fast. Spin a rooster.
It's pain. It's cold. And that's what I call high quality H2O.
That's what you need. That's what you need. It's some high quality H2O.
I need some Gatorade. All right, so second free throw is no good. 27-25 Pirates. I thought it was 26, but I like 25. 2 minutes on the clock. Going against that 2-3. Now they're going.
Oh, he's holding Dustin.
Connor Mullins takes it baseline, spins it out, shoots the little runner. No good. Holden gets pushed. They don't call it. Up the floor quickly, deflected out of bounds by Darnell. Good job, Dustin Darnell. Way to play hard, my man.
And there hasn't been many breaks in action in the second quarter either here. I don't think either team's took a timeout, have they?
Nope. Well, we've taken one.
One? Okay.
Yes. 27-25, 2:04 on the clock. Pirates up two.
Because I've been waiting for my new Steve Sutton story.
I know.
The next time out, but no one's taking one. And it's a dandy.
He just traveled right there, but no call. Over to Howe in the corner. They're looking to really flood the baseline. If we trap it, they're going to be in danger. Jake Reed for three, no good. Rebounded by Holden. He goes up above the trees. Holden bringing it across. We're going to have numbers here. Holden taking it coast to coast. Good look to Justin Salyers. Little flip pass. Justin with the finish.
The loop-de-loop spinnerooski.
Tigers down the floor quickly again. Lowry gets fouled. No call. Remington steals it, and then Lowry fouls out of frustration.
Yep.
The trail official's got to call that because it's his angle to look at that.
Yep. Wow.
29-25, 1:29 on the clock. Now Cole Lowry's got three fouls.
Man, that's a huge call.
That is, because honestly, it's a no call, and then the same play.
Right.
It was called.
That's the frustration.
I don't argue that the second call is a foul. It was, but right. The first call wasn't called. It was a foul.
Right, because Cole went up to get the rebound. He bumped him and made him fall down.
Yeah.
To put us in the place in the first place.
First free throws up and good.
Now
double bonus for everyone now. 29-26 Pirates. 1:29 on the clock. Truitt comes in the game.
Which he will be playing with two fouls also. So you got Holden and Truitt on the floor. Playing with two fouls.
And then Dyer's on the bench, but he's got two.
And then Cole Lowry now has three.
Second free throw up by Remington is good. 29-27. 1:20 on the clock. Remington guarding closely. Ball's deflected. And it will stay with the Pirates. Holden's got to do a little better job of keeping that ball down against Remington. He is quick.
Yeah. I just think Tanner still got to get his handle a little bit more. More time in the gym. More time. That's going to come.
So sideline out of bounds here, 1:21 on the clock. Pirates up two. Good backdoor cut, but he gets fouled, no called again. Rebounded by Tigers, Dustin Darnell, and they call a foul. That was not a good foul.
Hey, look at this shout out. Probably shouldn't say that, but we got Go Bird from the Costers. Thank you, Costers, for listening.
Absolutely. Seems like the entire Wheelersburg squad has two fouls. All right, so 1:15 on the clock, 29-27. It's hard to keep up with these shout-outs.
Yes, it is, but keep them coming.
Yep.
Keep them coming, 580-2036.
29-28, first free throw up and good by Dunn.
Shout-out to Coach Ader.
Second free throw up and good, 29-29, 1:10 on the clock, tie ball game. Got to finish. Holden brings across the timeline, gives it to Truitt, going a little dribble drive action. Skips it over to Justin Salyers. Looking to post up Holden. Darnell for three, no good. Got to get it into Holden right there. He's got a mismatch. Dunn brings it across the timeline quickly. Goes up against three guys. Misses it. Rebounded by Oh, that's terrible. Adrian got a boxing and good. 31-29, timeout, Tigers. 31-29, Tigers are up two with 44 seconds to go. Here's your chance.
30-second timeout. All right, quick Sutton story of the week brought to you by Schmidt's Family Restaurants. All right, so Steve Sutton, he was looking for a job a few months ago, and he would come over to my house, and I'd help him on his resumes and cover letters and things like that. Well, after a couple weeks of doing this, I kind of got frisky one day and said, hey, Steve, let's not put Steve on your resume. Let's put Steven. How do you spell it? With a P-H or a V? And he looks at me, and he goes, I don't know. I get confused. Aaron gets mad at me. So Steve Sutton, more of the story is Steve Sutton did not know how to spell his first name.
I mean, who's going to hire you if you can't spell your first name? Come on, Steve. You're better than that. You are better than that. Again, that was brought to you by Schmidt's Family Restaurant. If you're not entertained with that one, you don't love America. 44 seconds.
And Aaron did finally clarify what it was. I can't remember now what it was, but I think he spells it with a V.
All right, so what's the important part here, the last 44 seconds? The Pirates are down two here. They went on a little run.
Well, I think we got to get a good possession right here offensively.
All right, Truitt gets the ball inbounds, goes against pressure, goes into the paint, kicks it out. Darnell Wisely kicks it back out to Truitt, looking inside the hole, and they're doubling him.
Tripling
him. Quadrupling him. Kicks it back out to Darnell. Throws it into Holden again, and they foul him. Good. That's great coaching. I mean, Remington's probably, what, 5'11", 5'10"? Holden's
Remington is 5'10".
With Holden's hair, he's 6'12". So, got to go to the big fella. Don't forget, at halftime, Dusty the True Salaries will be with you. Stats brought to you by Dempsey's Heating and Air. And Tommy Tebow and I will give you our first half analysis.
Shout out to the refs. They're using the Dirt Devil right now.
The Dirt Devil. That's exactly right. First free throw up and good. Holden right now, three for three right now from the line.
And we got a couple extra Bruce Moore official ratings.
We do.
I think the fans will
well,
like.
Well, he helped us. That's why.
He did help us. Unfortunately, he helped us on one of them.
Yes, he did.
But he helped us.
Second free throw up and no good. 31-30 Tigers, 20 seconds to go. I look for the Tigers to go to Howell for sure. Tigers across the timeline. 12 seconds on the clock. Pirates staying in that 2-3. 8-7. There's a flare screen for Howell. Howell looking inside. Good look to Adrian and a finish. 3 seconds. Two.
Shoot it.
One. Half-court shot up by Truitt. Oh! That's your end of the two quarters. Your first half. Waverly, 33. Pirates, 30. We'll be back.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet. When hearts like ours meet, I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
All right, and we're back with the truth, Dusty Salyers, with our halftime stats. Dusty, tell me what you got.
All right, here's our halftime stats brought to you by Dempsey's Heating and Cooling. Let's go over the scoring real quick. Pretty balanced. Tanner Holden leads the Pirates with 7 points, him and Lowry. Lowry also has 7. J.J. Truitt has 5. Connor Mullins has 5. Justin Sayers has 2, and Dustin Darnell has 2. Free throws, we were 5 for 8, which is a little better than last week. Tanner Holden leads us in rebounding with 8. Lowry has 2 rebounds. Truitt with 1. Mullins with 2. Mac Dyer, I'm sorry, I missed Mac. Mac had 1 point. He was 1 for 2 from the free throw line, and he also has 1 rebound and 1 steal. Justin Sayers has a bucket and 2 rebounds.
So who's leading us as an assist, Dust?
Looks like Tanner's leading us with 3 assists. Lowry has 2, and Darnell has 1.
It looked like we kind of turned it over a little bit there in the first half. I know we had some steals as well. So how many turnovers, how many steals?
We had 10 turnovers and 5 steals.
10 turnovers, 5 steals. What's your thoughts right now so far after the first half?
Well, this is good for us, I think. The pace is totally different than last week. We're having to play up and down the floor, playing with a little foul trouble. We're not able to get out and defend like we really want to because of foul trouble. We got Lowry with 3 fouls, Holden with 2 fouls, Truitt with 2 fouls, Dyer with 2 fouls, and Darnell with 2 fouls.
And they also have some foul trouble, which we're not real sure on. But after one, it was the Pirates were up 16-15. And then in the second quarter, the Tigers won that quarter 18-14, and they go in the locker room up 3. So that's kind of where we're at right now. Dusty, the True Sires, we really, truly appreciate that. Thank you for your halftime stats. Again, that was brought to you by Dempsey Heating and Air. We appreciate all our sponsors. And once again, our sponsors include, let me grab my sheet real quick. We got Deemers. We got Glockner's. We got Dempsey's Heating and Air, Johnson's Shirt Stop, the Sea Store, Deemer's Market again, Cottle Trailer Sales, Glockner's, I already said, Ridge Mini Mart, Misty's Cone Shop, Johnson's Shirt Stop. I don't hear anything. Yeah, there we go. Johnson's Shirt Stop. And then that kind of wraps up our sponsors. First of all, at halftime, a couple segments we like to do. Before we get to our segments, though, Dusty kind of gave us his thoughts. He said he liked the pace of play, liked where we were at, liked the energy level of the Pirates. Tommy, what do you think so far?
I agree. I love the pace of play. I love our energy level. I think it kind of comes down to one of your keys to the game, which was our role players to come in and handle the ball, and they have not. Another key of the game is for Cole to have to be able to carry some of the load offensively, and his shot just not falling. He's gotten good looks, and they're just not falling right now early in the season. So he's going to keep shooting them, and he's good enough that he'll eventually fix it.
And a couple of our keys were basically – a couple of keys defensively. One was transition defense, which I think we're doing okay at. The second one is closing out on the shooters, which, again, I think we're doing okay at. But actually, one of our offensive keys was taking care of the basketball, and that we have 10 turnovers, and that's really kind of led to a lot of their points. The other thing we got to do a better job of in the second half, in my opinion, is a little bit of help and recover. We got to keep that ball out of the paint. Right now they're kind of driving it down our throat a little bit too much. We got to do a better job of helping and also kind of rotating on the backside as far as our defense goes. Here's another thing. Holden's only got 8 rebounds but 0 offensive rebounds. He's got to get in there and make something happen.
Yeah, well, when you're not establishing any offense and we're just shooting off of transition, that's sometimes pretty tough. I got a couple shout-outs to get caught up on. Shout-out from the E-Steps. Caden E-Steps says, go Warriors. Caden, you're in trouble come Monday. You're going to be writing some sentences. And he says, if we run out of sentence stories, he's got plenty. And
I bet he does. Caden.
And go Bird from Estel Otney. We love you, Estel.
Good job, Estel. Shout-out to the Elf on the Shelf. Shout-out to the pedestrians outside the gym. I don't know what that means, but we'll take it. A couple Bruce Moore official halftime rating brought to you by Glockner's. We make it easy. Our ratings are as follows, Tommy Tebow.
Right,
garbage, Elbow Lisa bad, Dirt Devil bad, and we know what a Dirt Devil does. It's a vacuum. Dirty Diaper bad, and Bruce Moore in an extra small sauna suit bad.
And I don't even think bad's the right word for that because I've witnessed that. and
that will damage you. It will damage you.
I don't think bad is the correct word.
So we need to call it Bruce Moore in an extra small sauna suit damaged brain bad.
Yes.
Okay, I got it. And I'm going to go with a different one. I, you know, Bruce was nice enough to give us these, but I think, honestly, I don't see the officiating being a huge issue right now. I really don't. For how the game's being played and how helter-skeltered, it's a tough game to call.
It is, and basketball officiating is tough to call. The only one, my biggest, I guess, one would be, which puts me in the second category of elbow Lisa bad, is just
Lowry. Is that what you're going to say?
The no call on Lowry, and then him to pick up his third, because that's so huge for us, for him to come out with his third foul. I mean, that's our second leading scorer, or first leading scorer, our first game. But
well, we're going to go to a little segment we call Tommy Tebow's edition of Would You Rather. All right, we're going to do a quick six, Tommy.
All right.
I'm going to give you six questions. You're going to have to answer as fast as you can. All right, so here they are. And he does not know what I'm going to say, so here we go. Tommy Tebow, would you rather take a charge or have a great assist?
Charge.
I love you. Would you rather play basketball indoors or at Tanland?
Outdoors. Tanland, baby.
I like it. Would you rather eat dinner with the Duke, Rob Willard, or Mean Gene?
I got to go with the Duke.
The Duke.
Sorry, Mean Gene.
We do like you, but not for dinner.
Mean Gene did leave me in the middle of a podcast. My first podcast. Mean Gene sets us up. We're doing the podcast. He doesn't let me know anything, and all of a sudden he looks at me and goes, "Hey, I got to go to the concert. See ya."
That's why you don't eat dinner with a guy.
That's right.
Number five.
He might leave me with a check.
He would. Shout out to Mr. Porter. Just walked by. All right, number four. Have a solid point guard or a great post player?
Post player.
Oh, you're going post. I go point. Number five, listen to Rex or Eddie Deamer on Bug Fan.
I got to go with Deamer.
Deamer's chicken. All right, this is a good
because
one.
Because he gives us free chicken.
Number six, eat Deamer's chicken or KFC?
Deamer's chicken, hands down, all day, every day. It's greasy, but it's worth it.
Segment was sponsored to you by Ruck Daddy Incorporated. We'll be back. Third quarter starts in 2 minutes.
And we're back, Berg fans. And I'd first like to congratulate the JV team once again for their win. They moved to 2-0 on the season. They beat the Waverly JV 45-33 to move to 2-0.
Shout out to Ron the Barber, Nikki Tilly, listening live from Wolford's Landing. Happy birthday, Nick. We both turned 40 this year, Nikki. That means we're getting old. We're going to have arthritis soon.
Nikki told me she's 25.
Well, she is 25 in her mind, but she's not 25.
Oh.
All right, inbound at 33-30, Tigers. Connor Mullins across the timeline, looking to run that dribble drive action, little flip.
For the Pirates, you have Truitt, Justin Sires, Holden, Dyer, and Mullins.
Yep, going foul trouble from Lowry, so he's on the bench to start the second half. Drives it, kicks it over for Mac Dyer for three, no good, it's long. Rebounded by Remington, they got numbers. 3-on-2 break, Mullins looks to trip him up. Good help right there by Truitt. No good by Remington. Rebounded, though. Offensive rebound by Marquez. Kicked out for three for Adrian. No good. Again, an offensive rebound by Wolf. And out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Tigers.
That was a good job by Truitt, standing straight up defensively, not getting called for a third foul.
Three offensive rebounds there on that first trip. That's not good. We got to get
a
box.
That's not good. No.
7-23, 33-30, Tigers. Come on, Pirates. All right, side out of bounds is inbounded to Remington. Pirates and man. Tigers looking to go a little four out, one in, like we talked in the scouting report. It's deflected but kicked out to Marquez. Marquez skips it over to Remington. Remington looked to put it on the deck. Kicks it to Howe for three. Good closeout by Truitt. And now on top to Marquez, and everybody's taking a breather. Looking inside, not there. Howe putting it on the deck. Penetrates and kicks to Adrian. Again, Tigers in that four out one in with screen away and just kind of some back screens every now and then, kind of Wisconsin-like.
Adrian Scanson
puts it on the deck, kicks it to Howe for three, and good.
Baby Lions are the devil.
They are. 36-30. Tigers are looking to wear us down with that full court pressure. Holden drives it in, gets fouled, no call, goes off the glass, no good. Again, the Tigers with numbers. Two-on-one break to Marquez. He travels, no call, block, nope. They call foul.
That was not a foul.
And that's his third foul.
That's not a foul. They're calling that because he fell down. That was it. He got all ball, went straight up, got all ball. Offensive guy falls down, so they call a foul.
That's sauna suit bad is what that is.
That's a reaction foul.
Daggone it. That's his third, too. First free throw's up and no good. 6:29 on the clock, 36-30. Tigers. This segment right here is going to be crucial for the Pirates. Second free throw up and good.
And the Pirates definitely got to not be like us and worry about the officials. They just got to play. They got to fight through that because every game the officials are going to have bad calls. They just got to play.
Holden drives it, kicks it to Dyer. It's blocked. Same as the other end, but no call. Kicked over to Marquez. He drives it baseline. Good help by Holden.
The difference was our guy didn't fault.
Adrian up off the glass, no good. Scramble for the ball and then kick to Holden. Holden coming down in transition, going against. Good little up and under. No good.
He wanted to dunk it.
He should have just went up strong, but yep. He missed it. Tigers back the other way with Wolf. Wolf drives it, creates the contact, no call. And an offensive rebound again by the Tigers.
Loose ball.
Ball's on the floor, picked up by Truitt. Truitt bringing it down the timeline quickly. Kicks it over to Holden. Holden on the perimeter. Kicks it up to Mullins.
Tanner's got to get the ball here to take control.
We got to do a better job on the glass and getting back on defense. Mullins for three. No good.
In and out.
They're holding his arm, and they call a jump ball. They had a hold of Mac Dyer's arm. They don't call it. They call a jump ball instead. They were tangled like WWE wrestlers, like Twizzlers. 5:32 on the clock. Pirates down 7. Timeout, Coach Ader. We will be back. 37-30, Tigers. 5:32 on the clock, third quarter. That song goes out to our striped fellas that are officiating Can't You See by Marshall Tucker Band. Right now, the Pirates have not done a very good job of, one, transition defense, two, getting on the defensive glass, and then three, handling their slappy, whatever you want to call it, barnyard slap rules.
Yeah, I mean, how many offensive rebounds does Waverly have so far in the second half? At least
five, at least.
Yeah.
At least five. They had three the first possession. They had a couple the next, so at least that.
Rob Woodward, shout out to the music choices.
That's what I'm talking about, Captain. I know you like that song. I sing a song called SOC, too. I like that one.
We need to get a Rob Woodward original on here.
Inbounds, throws the ball inside Adrian, and Adrian shoves somebody. And they give him a warning.
All right. Pirates going to have to weather this storm right now. 39-30 Waverly. Waverly on a big run to start the third. Same thing we saw out at Northwest.
That's right. 6-0 run by the Tigers. 39-30 Waverly. 5:18 on the clock. We need a good possession right here.
Connor clears the floor. Take it up one-on-one against Howe.
Howe's a pretty strong fella.
Yeah.
Mullins gets it across the timeline. Skips it over to Darnell. Darnell on top of the key. Looking to give it up. Gives it up to Mullins. Skipped over to Salyers. Holden's got to assert himself right here. Holden with the ball. They're checking him, and they call foul. Good. About time. Holden's got to be aggressive.
Yep.
And I don't know how much longer Lowry can sit there.
4:51 left here in the third.
I know he's got three, but I feel like he's the second offensive threat we got to have.
Yeah, hopefully when he comes in, wherever he's got their subs in, we can make that run again against their subs.
And right now, Holden's got to assert himself. He drives it. He kicks it.
Inside
Mullins
out.
Mullins for three. No good. And then they're going to run again. We don't have a safety. Remington, bring the ball back down the floor. He does get stopped by Darnell. Darnell does a good job checking him and catching him and keeping him from scoring. Kicked over to number 12 for Adrian, then back over to Hoover, number two. Hoover on top. Hoover hands it off to Marquez. Marquez waiting on a set. Looks like it's going to go to Howe. Skipped over to Remington. Remington drives baseline. Good block by Dyer. Out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Tigers. 39-30, 4:14 on the clock.
I think if we're going to make a run, it's all going to start defensively, both just with pressure and rebounding.
All right, the Tigers looking to inbound it. Nothing really open. They give it to Adrian. Adrian with a significant size advantage on Darnell, but Darnell does his good job. Rebounded by Holden. Holden, against pressure, drives it all the way, gets hacked, and goes up, and no good. But two free throws coming.
Here comes Truitt and Lowry into the game.
I like that move. I like that move. I mean, we said that 14, 15 seconds ago, and both those kids are coming in the game. Got to have them because we've got to have some offense.
Yep.
I mean, the team out there right now, they're playing their guts out, but they're not an offensive unit. Give me some high-quality H2O.
It's why you drink a Gatorade.
It's cold. And that's what I call high-quality H2O.
First free throw is up and no good.
Dandy Lions are the devil.
Truitt and Lowry subs in for Justin Sires and Darnell.
Reminder, shout-out line, new number, 740-580-2036. Send us your shout-outs.
39-30 Tigers. Holden with his second free throw. Good job. And in and out. Rebounded by Adrian. Back down the floor. Over to Reed. Reed is in. He's kind of the bruiser of the group. Skipped over to 23. Wolf, not there. Back on top to Reed. He travels. No call. Drives it and finishes. 41-30, Tigers. Mullins against full court pressure. Now gives it up to Holden. Reed just grabs him. No call. I'd go 1-4 low right now against him. He drives it. Kicks it to Dyer. Dyer with the left. Off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Reed. He's got to be a little more patient in the paint, Tommy.
Yeah, we're letting Waverly's pressure get us too helter-skelter
right now.
That's what they want to do.
A little more ball movement. Okay, skipped over to Marquez. Tigers being a little more patient right now. I mean, they have been pretty patient, honestly. Reed for three, and good. 44-30, 3 minutes on the clock. Timeout, Wheelersburg. We'll be back.
Jump off, nobody gonna know. Can't you see? Oh, can't you see what that woman, Lord, she been doing to me? Can't you see? Can't you see what that woman?
All right, Pirate fans, we are back. It is 44-30, Waverly. And right now, Waverly is on 11-0 run to start the third quarter.
And they've kind of subbed a little more than us in the third quarter. We're kind of, you know, we're kind of like Santa Cruz here. We need to not be the banana slugs and be the Energizer bunnies. Right now, we need to kind of pick up the energy level.
Yeah, we need to see the same energy we started the game with.
And, you know, that's to be expected.
Yes, it is.
It's a young group out there, really. You got Lowry and Holden, who's got some experience, Dyer with some as well. And the rest of those guys are kind of new at this, to be honest. So,
and this is a frantic environment, mm-hmm. a frantic pace, you know, a frantic type of game. It's tough.
Yep. All right, so Lowry back in the game now. Lowry brings it across the timeline. I like him bringing it up. He's going to be a good player by the end of the year for sure. Of course, he's got 25 the first quarter.
Shout out from the Newsoms. Great job, fellas. Get you some.
I like it, Noose. Danny Lines or the devil. Lowry picks up his dribble, kicks it over to Mullins up top. A little more ball movement this possession, and they foul inside. Hoover just holding on to him. And Tanner wisely walks away.
And Tanner got a little.
Maybe they need to get him back in the coaching box. What do you think of that? Those gray boots are past the midcourt. I thought that a coaching box was really limited to the bench.
See, that's why he stopped wearing the orange shoes, though, because when he wore the orange shoes, it was so obvious out of the coaching box they could see him.
He tries to push him back now, but he's still out there.
Now he's like a ninja.
He's got to get in the coaching box. You can't go out to half court. All right, inbounded to Holden. Holden in the corner, drives it. Good little two-foot stop, and he gets hacked on the arm.
And I think you can see Tanner's going to look to take over right now.
All right, so while we're waiting on the two free throws, I'll go ahead and tell you. So 38 free throws to 7. I'm going to say it fast. At Unioto, we're down 7, 40 seconds to go. Have no chance to win because the officials called everything under the sun. And I told one of my players to face guard the official. The official comes over to me and he says, "Coach, did you tell 14 to face guard you?" I said, "Absolutely. You're the best player they got." He teased me up, and I said, "That's the best call you've made all night." And I sat down. And we lost.
Why is it against the rule to guard the official?
I don't know.
They're on the court.
He's on the court.
You're not touching him.
He's creating lots of point opportunities for them.
Yeah.
First free throw up and good. That's as quick as I can tell that story. 44-31. Pirates second free throw going up and good. 44-32 Tigers. Pirates down 12, 2:40 on the clock. Tigers down the floor super fast and finishes. And they – officials called timeout.
Jeez, this drives me crazy right here when they have to do this stuff.
Well, I mean,
they're letting the game get out of control. Then they have to stop the game to tell guys, "Hey, stop pushing each other because we've let you do that all night."
Well, unfortunately, that's the key. Score again is Waverly 46, the Pirates 32. Trying to get control of this game a little bit. Number 20 is pretty physical right now. He's over there nose to nose with Holden. Gosh. About 80 feet from the basket.
Shout out to Aaron Sutton for helping Steve spell his name correctly.
2:31 on the clock. Pirates down 14. Ball stolen away by the Pirate or by the Tigers. Tigers brings it down. Jake Reed on top, skips it back on top to Remington. Remington drives it, kicks it out for three for Adrian. Adrian misses. No box out. And the ball is tipped out of bounds and stays with the Tigers. I agree, Mean Gene. I should have thrown a chair. Bad verb tense. 46-32, 2:15 on the clock now. Reed on top, looking inside to Adrian. Adrian drives it. No help, but he misses it because a good block there by Lowry. Remington strips it, and Waverly calls timeout.
That's it. That's a hustle play right now. That's a 50-50 ball that Waverly gets and able to – be headsy and call a timeout.
All right, so 46-32, folks. Full timeout, 2:03 on the clock. We'll be back, and hopefully the Pirates will come back with some energy. All right, and we're back, Pirate fans. Score of this one right now in the third quarter is 46, Waverly, 32, Wheelersburg. And right now, this is exactly what happened against Northwest. I mean, these guys have only been in the gym for 2 weeks, and our conditioning is kind of showing. You know, when you go on that long state football run, you know, it's just a totally different kind of exercise than football.
Yep. Yeah, you could be in the best shape in the world for football. First day in the gym and basketball, you make it about three times on the floor, and you're hurting.
That's right. Because in football, you play, you stop. You play, you stop. Basketball, you just keep playing.
Yep.
Jake Reed gets the ball in bounds, drives it, shoots the runner, no good. Again, no box. Remington gets another rebound, goes up, no good. And then Lowry comes away with it. He's getting killed in there, and they finally call a foul on Reed.
To use the Coach Barrick term, we got too many guys in the graveyard trying to rebound.
Well, I don't call it a graveyard, but I call it this. You put a butt in their body and you push back. It's that simple. And we've got to make sure that that's the, that's kind of the little things that go with conditioning, though, honestly.
Yeah, I don't see anybody with bent knees and bent down and trying to get that push.
The great John Wooden once said, and remember this, folks, fatigue makes cowards of us all. And that's kind of – right now we need to pick it up a notch. 140 on the clock.
He seemed like he knew what he was doing a little bit.
Yeah, he might add some good players like, I don't know, Kareem and some other folks like Bill Walton. All right, holding across the timeline, gives it to Truitt. Truitt drives it, spins off the glass,
that
and
was
good.
Smooth.
That was a great move. 46-34,
oh,
great
shakalaka.
Set. Great set out of that timeout. 130 on the clock. Pirates down 12. Reed's pressured, kicks it to Remington. Then over to Adrian. Adrian drives it. Kicks it over to Remington again. Kind of traveled, didn't call it. Reed on the left wing. He drives it, no.
Charge.
Oh, that's a charge. It's offensive. Yes! Offensive foul.
Has to be. He is so out of control. He's gotten a little momentum. Reed has hitting a couple shots, and he's just been barreling in there.
And that is J.J. Truitt's third offensive foul. And Coach Robertson's arguing, and he has no reason to argue.
No.
None. I mean, he just ran him over like tractor trailer. So 46-34, 1:12 on the clock. Got to get a good shot here. Finish this quarter on a little 5 or 6-0 run and bring it back to single digits and see what we got in the fourth.
I also see Coach Robertson got Kyle Miller on his staff this year. I think that's a great addition for him. Kyle Miller was a great player, was a coach at Western there for a couple years. I think that's going to be a great addition for them.
Yeah, but I don't care about Waverly.
That's true.
I don't. Holden inbounded to Holden. Across the timeline. Kicks it up to Truitt. Truitt bobbles it, but gets it back. Drives it. Little 15-foot pull-up and good. Truitt asserting himself, that third scorer like we've talked about.
Yeah.
Well, Pirates right down 10. And
come
then they call
on
a bump foul. And you know what that is?
A make-up for Robertson yelling so
all
much.
All that is we've got six fouls. They've got one. Got to call something and even it up. That's what that is.
And you got their coach over there yelling for that, and then they just call it.
Yep. Six fouls on the Tigers and now two on the Pirates.
That's an
offensive. Got to be offensive. Shove off. Absolutely. Adrian kind of reached into Holden, extended his arm, and they call it. I tell you what, I love it. Here's that run we were talking about.
Let's do it, baby.
Let's go, Berg.
Let's go.
All right, 46-36, 53 seconds on the clock.
On the floor for the Pirates, you have the starters, Truitt, Lowry, Holden, Dyer, and Mullins.
And for the Tigers, you've got 30 Dunn, 2 Hoover, 5 Remington, 1 Marquez, and 12 Adrian. Lowry across the timeline drives it, and they got a hold on him,
come
and we're going to be in the bonus, people. Going to be a 1-on-1.
Foul fest.
Now they have 8 fouls.
But I hate when referees talk to the fans too.
Yes. Like, 46-36, 44 seconds on the clock.
I mean, that would be tough with basketball officials. The fans are right there, but you can't talk to the fans. Just call the game.
Unless you're talking to Berg fan.
Unless you're talking to us.
You can talk to Berg fan.
Yeah. They're talking to Chad May and Chad Johnson.
Well, that's because they've got nice beards. Nice beards from Harvard Yard. All right, Justin Sayers is now checking in for Truitt just to make sure he doesn't pick up his third.
Yeah, 44 seconds to go here in the third.
And I imagine Darnell is going to check in for Lowry after these free throws to keep him from getting his fourth.
Yes, he is.
So the Pirates are going to be in the bonus the rest of the game and in a couple fouls, the double bonus. So free throws are going to be critical.
Yeah, got to take advantage. Here comes the Berg train
from Ricky Stipp.
Woo!
First free throw up and good. You like that, Rick? Uh-huh.
Woo!
46-37. Pirates down 9, 44 seconds. Second free throw. Lowry takes a couple dribbles and makes it. Good job, Cole. Way to come in and spark the group. They were up 14. Now they're up 8. This is exactly what we need. I said get it to about 6, and let's finish this puppy off in the fourth quarter. Good game management by Coach Ader, honestly.
Yep.
Great coach management. Or game management. 40 seconds, 46-38.
Yes, once you start getting all those fouls, your game plan goes out the window, and you got to manage the game and get guys on the floor that's going to make a run.
They're looking to hold for the last shot, 30 seconds. Remington's just holding on top. Darnell's just giving him some space. Now Darnell comes out and guards him, so they count. 20 seconds on the clock to Marquez. Dyer Garden, 15 seconds on the clock. 12. Now they're going to run a set. Gives it to Remington. Remington goes baseline. Looks in the kick over to Lowry. Or excuse me, Howe. No good. Tipped away. Then to Marquez. Marquez goes up strong and gets fouled with 3.6 seconds on the clock in the third quarter. That'd be two free throws. That ball is bobbled more than the state fair when you throw that ping pong and it goes ding, 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 ding. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do. And right now you got to be, if you're Willersburg, you got to be thinking 3.6, be able to get a somewhat of a decent heave at the basket here. Too many times this guy's let this run out and make it a full court shot. We can get it up here to maybe even a three.
Uh-huh.
If we can push it.
Really, it's almost 4 seconds. First free throw, no good. Shout out to Jim Bastine and Misty's cone shop. I tell you, there's nothing better than a Misty's footer with a little bit of sauce, a little bit of ketchup, a little mustard, a little onion. And a little vanilla milkshake.
I got to go peanut butter there.
You go peanut butter?
Peanut butter.
Oh, and I'll tell you what else. Cheese balls, broccoli bites, corn nuggets.
Cheese balls. I agree with the cheese balls.
Second free throw up. No good. Holden gets the rebound. 2-1. Gets kind of bumped a little, but no call. That'll end your third quarter. Waverly, 46. Wheelersburg, 38. And we will be back for the fourth quarter action.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Not a yes sir, not a follower. Fit the box, fit the mold, have a seat in the foyer. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, thunder, thunder.
All right, and we're back. 46-38. Waverly's up 8 going into the fourth quarter. Lowry's got 9 points. Truett's got 9 points and 3 charges. Holden's got 9 points, and he also has 10 rebounds. Mark my word, Lowry is going to have a great fourth quarter. Guaranteed. Again, I'm going to give a shout-out to Leslie, your wife. I'm going to give a shout-out to my wife, Natalie, for letting us do this, and our kids. All right. Gray, Finn, I'll let you do your shout-out for yours.
Shout-out to Kinsley Joe, who saw Santa last night for the first time.
That's what I'm talking
about. Big old smile on her face.
And also, your daughter loves to kind of get down with it when it comes to rap songs.
Oh, she likes the gangster rap.
She does. She likes the NWA. Here we go. 46-38, 8 minutes, Pirate basketball. It'll be inbounded to Lowry. Again, I'm telling you right now, he's going to have a good fourth quarter. Trust me, because he's rested, because he's been in foul trouble. Mullins on top. Looking to set the O. Looking to drive it. Drives it. Good 2-foot stop. Kicks it to Lowry. Lowry fakes the three. Gets kind of hacked.
Something.
No call.
How do you not call it?
Kicked to Truett for three. No good. Rebounded by Dyer. He gets slapped out of his hands, but it goes out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Pirates.
All the stuff they've called this game, and they don't call anything there.
I mean, they kind of tore his jersey off a little.
I mean, the defender falls down. Cole almost fell down.
But I'm telling you right now, I'm done crying about it. Done.
Okay.
Because we're going to come back. Holden looking to inbound it, but not there. Yo, almost stolen. But inbound it back to Holden. Holden drives it. Kicks it to Lowry. Lowry's got a three, but he fakes it. Lowry skips it over to Holden. Back to Truett. Truett drives it from the baseline. Goes up strong off the glass. And good! That puts one in double figures. 46-40. Pirates. Berg train's coming.
You sound like a big choo-choo train.
I sound like Captain Insano. Captain Insano. All right, ball's kicked to Adrian for the elbow, then back up to Remington up top, looking in the post. Good job by Truett stealing it. Got numbers, Truett. Brings it across the timeline, then slows it down to Lowry. Lowry looking to pull for three. No good. And they call an over-the-back call. Excuse me, they call a hold on Marquez. He argues with the official, and the official says, what you talking about, Willis?
What you talking about, Willis?
Because Dandelions are the devil.
Just ask Dave Newsom.
The devil.
All right, real quick while we got a little booing going on, give me a little Havid Yad. Your boy, Boston Brent.
I like it.
Havid Yad.
Ha, ha.
Havid Yad.
Ha, ha. Havid Yad.
So, hold on. Why is Remington at the free throw line? Why is Waverly's guy at the free throw line at our basket? Explain that to me.
Tanner. I don't think I can.
I don't even understand it.
I don't know what's going on right now.
He's like, I'm shooting on their end. What are you talking about? He's arguing. He's like, all right, maybe I'm not shooting.
Yeah.
So Holden is going to shoot a 1-1 to cut the game to 4 points.
I think Remington wants to be on our team.
I think he does. Well, who doesn't want to be with Dupper? First free throw is up and good. Good job. Attaboy, Tanner. 46th, Waverly. 41, Wheelersburg. 6:50 in the fourth quarter. Second free throw coming back.
I love that, Havid Yad.
And it's going to come down right now to the defense. That's right. Got to get stops. And again, we're in the bonus, and they're far from it. Second free throw is up and good. Good stroke right there. Kept the head still. 46-42. Going to make a little run here, boys and girls. Kicks it over to Adrian. Adrian dribbles it on top. Kicks it to Howe on the right wing. Howe kicks to Marquez in the corner. Marquez drives it up. Looks to spin dribble. Takes the little bad help him recover. Takes it in for a layup. 48-42. Up quick to Dyer. Dyer with the left hand. And the finish. 48-44. 6:20.
Great find by Tanner Holden. Great finish. Mac Dyer.
Got to do a better job of guarding the basketball.
Yes. Way too easy for Marquez last time. Straight line, penetration, easy layup.
And, you know, you don't have to body him. Just give him a little space.
Yep. Marquez is quick.
Look like they're stopping the game for something.
Coach Eater needed an explanation on something.
I'm not real sure what, but.
Hey, Trent DeMare-Sayers is working his way down the bench.
Look at him. He wants to get in.
He might go in. Knowing Trent, he might go into this game.
Absolutely. You know why? He's the mayor.
He's the mayor.
Inbound at 48-44. Tigers are up 4, 6:22 on the clock.
Is there a rule about playing in a walking boot?
I think, but you know what? I had a guy face guarding officials. What do you think? All right, kicked out the Howe for three, and good.
Ah! Daggone it.
51-44. They're bodying him the whole way down. Tanner Holden takes it inside, goes up strong, and finishes.
Coast to coast.
That puts him in double digits. 51-46. Tigers back down the floor quickly. Wolf with the basketball on top to Howe. No hand up in his face. He shoots three and makes it. Got to call timeout now. He said, Coach Hader, I just saw him. Keep your hand up. Don't put your hand on his chest. Keep it up high.
Hand down, man down.
Truitt drives. Little spin. Little fadeaway. Rebounded by Lowry. Lowry on top to Holden. Holden takes it in tight. Goes up strong with the left and finishes. Got to have a stop right here.
Tanner Holden is looking to take over this fourth quarter.
54-48, Waverly, 5:20 on the clock. Across the timeline is Wolf. Now to Marquez. Got to get a hand up on him. Come on, Mac. They're running a set right for him. Good switch right there by Holden. Holden on Howe now. He says, you ain't shooting that again. Over to Remington. Remington looking to go inside to Adrian. Adrian. And then there's kind of a bump by Dyer. It'll be underneath Waverly basketball. That'll be the fourth foul on the Pirates.
54-48, Waverly, 5:09 to go in the third.
Don't forget your post-game show, Dave Watts, because just like Dave Watts, the end is near, brother. The end is near. Love you, Dave.
We love you, Wattsy.
54-48, 5:09, inbounded it to Wolf. Wolf goes up strong. Good help right there by Dyer. Ball's tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with the Tigers. And once again, Coach Robertson has to come out of the coaching box because apparently that's where his – camper is.
And once again, the referees allow him to do so.
Exactly. Oh, a little straight line. Oh, but he misses the layup. Good. Rebounded by Dyer. Holding against two people. Good job pressure. Keeping the ball against pressure. Holding. Just a turnover. Yeah. Throws it out of bounds. I like when Lowry goes and gets that. He's really good against pressure. Lowry's got to go back and get the ball. Come on. 54-48. 4:50 on the clock. Come on, Bird Train. Marquez across the timeline going up against Mullins. Setting a flare screen for Howe. Howe fakes it, gives it up to Adrian inside. He goes up and gets fouled by Mullins. That'll be two free throws. 4:39 on the clock. Not sure how many timeouts we have, but I think we have maybe two. You think that's right?
Yeah.
Two or three?
Sounds right. Right now, we're just not doing a good job on the ball pressure. Too many guys have to come help because we can't guard on the ball.
Well, part of that was, Holden got a flare screen and then went to close out, but he didn't break down. And, the guy just went right by him, and then Dyer had to help, and there you are. But you're right.
And the rotation on the third rotation was too slow there.
Right.
And we foul.
Containing the dribble has been a problem all night, but they're pretty darn athletic. First free throw is up and good. 55-48. Again, 4 minutes, 39 seconds in the fourth quarter. That's our fifth foul. Second free throw is up and good. No good. Rebounded by Holden above the rim. All right, need a good bucket here. Holden going against Remington. Remington pressures. Holden drives, kicks it out to Mullins. Nothing there. Mullins kicks it over to Lowry. Lowry looking to shake and bake. Hits the backdoor cutter, and we throw it out of bounds again.
We're just forcing too many things on these back cuts.
Yeah, that's the second turnover in a row, and we really need to be taking care of the ball and own it. And that's the bottom line, is that I think Lowry's got to have the ball, but that's just not good decisions. Really, our two best offensive players had the ball the last two possessions, and we turned it over.
Yep.
One for Holden, one for Lowry. All right. Waverly's running another set here. Kicks it over to Remington off a ball screen. Nothing showing. Kicks it up top to Howe. Howe hits Remington off a flare. Remington drives the baseline, and Lowry blocks it. And it goes out of bounds.
And right now we're just going to get – we do a good job of pushing, but when that's not there, we're going to have to do a good job of backing it out and doing better in the quarter court offensively.
But you know what, though? I look at it this way. Being a head coach before, I mean, how many days do you have to put in sets? To ISO or you know what I mean?
Yeah, not many.
Right. So you kind of got to go with what your base offense. And, they've played a bunch of games. Wolf goes up, misses it, rebounded by Lowry. Lowry getting bumped, no call. Lowry does a good job against pressure again. And then the Pirates are going to go to this dribble drive action. Lowry driving it. Gets tripped up but kicks it out to Mullins on the left wing. Mullins now skips it to Truitt. Truitt looking to try to drive. Goes against Marquez. Good crossover and step back. And good! How about that move?
That's a good move.
Wow!
By a freshman.
Timeout.
Freshman.
Boom, shakalaka.
Okay. They call a official's timeout because we touched the basketball. 3:32 on the clock.
The Lions are the devil.
55-50. Tigers. Marquez across the timeline. Again, we're Pirates are down five. Got to have good help. Nobody's there, and we foul.
Truitt.
Connor kind of got beat off the bounce again.
Yep.
Just got to sit down and make sure that lead step is powerful. And that lead step's lagging a little bit.
Truitt's fourth foul.
Yeah, and again, he gets his foul off of helping.
Right.
And just got to do a better job of kind of containing the basketball. 3:24 now. There'll be two free throws by Marquez. And thankfully, he's not a good free throw shooter. I think I'd hack a Shaq him. That's what Coach Spradlin says, and I agree. He's missed the last four.
Hack a Marquez.
All right, second free throw is up. And just when we say it, he makes it. 56-50,
that's
Waverly.
That's your fault.
It is, but I liked hack a Marquez. Holden against pressure again. Kicks up a sideline. Mullins fakes a three. Puts it on the deck. Kicks it back out to Holden on the left wing. Looking to set a ball screen for Holden. Spreading the floor a little bit. Holden. Makes kind of a lazy pass, and they steal it away and bring it this way. Lowry goes up for the strip, misses it. Rebounded by Wolf and put back in. 58-50, 3 minutes. Lowry back across the timeline quickly. 15-foot pull-up. No,
good.
Good.
Got the roll.
Got some Spanish on it.
Yes, it did.
58-52, 2:48 on the clock. Marquez again. Across the timeline. Now they're slowing it down. 2:30. They look to go inside to Adrian. Adrian against Truitt, and he's got four fouls, so he just stands up, and they make the little bunny. 60-52, Tigers. 2:30 on the clock. Holden drives it. Backs him down. Goes up and gets fouled. That'll be two free throws. Forcing the action and got the call.
Yep.
So right now, 2:24 on the clock. Pirates are down eight. These two free throws are critical. How about the Spanish from Lowry? Folks, I said it was no good because it hit the rim 14 times.
Yeah, that's one 47. That keeps you on the edge of your seat. You don't know.
You don't know.
At first, you didn't think, and then you thought, okay, we got a chance, and it drops.
All right. Holden for two free throws. 224. It's been a really, really highly contested ball game. First free throw is up and rims in and out.
Once again, shout out to Andy Saltzman, who won our mascot challenge presented by Scott Verba. He won a free two-night stay at Wolford's Landing. Go hang out. I heard Christy Cottle make some good caramel corn. Try some of that.
Caramel corn. Got to get a stop after we make this free throw because he's going to make it. And he does. 60-53. Ruck Daddy Scouting Report says high-quality H2O and get a stop. Now the Pirates are bringing up full court pressure. Looks like the 2-2-1 look. Oh, got a steal! Lowry takes it, goes up strong off the glass, and good! 60-55,
oh,
2 minutes. Come on, get another stop. 2:10 on the clock. They got him in a trap, but he gets out of it. Marquez across the timeline, going fast. Howe from deep, and misses it. Rebounded by Dyer. They're playing
great
into
rebound,
our hands.
Max Dyer.
They're taking quick shots now. They don't need it, and I like the fact that they're taking them.
Pirates down five.
Holden over to Truitt. Truitt. Looking to drive, puts it on the deck, getting bumped, spins, goes up strong. They block it, and it's out of bounds. It stays with the Pirates. 1:46 on the clock.
60-55 Waverly.
And it looks like Coach Hayner is going to call a timeout, and we will be back in 30 seconds.
Have a yard. It's clean. It's cold. And that's what I call high quality H2O.
All right, Pirate fans, we're back. 20 seconds here on this timeout. And right now the Pirates down 60-55 with about 2 minutes to go on the clock. The Pirates have the ball under OB, and Coach Ader calls timeout to get what he wants. And right now this is when execution is paramount. I mean, it is so important right now that the Pirates get a good look or a foul, get fouled. And again, 60-55, 1 minute 46 seconds on the clock, fourth quarter action. All right, they're going to ISO Holden on the block, it looks like.
Against Remington.
And they're doubling him. They throw it up to him anyway. Oh, and then we turn it over. Remington back down the floor quickly. Holden strips it, and it goes off his leg, but they call that it stays with the Tigers. I thought the second official was going to come in and
– yeah, I mean, that one, I don't think either one of them got a great look at it.
Yeah, 140 after that turnover. You know, basically Holden tried to catch it high and tip it back, and they did a good job stealing it. On top to Howe. Howe shoots a three up five, and he makes it.
That's a tough shot.
And hand in his face. I'm not sure I agree with the shot selection, but it went in. Three from Mullins now, and it's good.
Bon-bon.
Yep. Coming back at you.
63-58,
120. Good pressure by Lowry in the quarter court. Now they're looking to trap, and they're trapping. He's stuck. And they call
timeout. Waverly.
1:17 on the clock. Pirates down five. Let's go
timeout.
Ahead and stay and talk here for a minute.
All right, here we go.
All right, so 63-58, down five, 1:17. Had to call that timeout.
Yeah. You're in the trap area. He couldn't move. Great trap by the Pirates. Forced the timeout.
They got exactly what they want. The next foul on the Pirates is one-on-one. My suggestion right now, not that I have an important thought, but I would foul Marquez. He has not been a good free throw shooter tonight. He's missed like all but one. I think he's 1 for 6 from the line.
You'd go hack a Marquez here.
I would go hack a Marquez right here. And then on the other end, I like the ball screen for Holden, and then, but I wouldn't set the ball screen. I'd have Lowry set it and then slip. You know, act like he's setting it and slip it because they're doubling that ball screen.
Yeah, they're highly aggressive against Tanner. Defensively here, if you don't hack a Marquez, you have to have great on-the-ball defense, mm-hmm. and we got a rebound.
If you know, good question is when do we foul? 1 minute 17 down five. I say one trap and then foul. We'll try to get a steal out of one trap, and maybe we can get a steal quick and go to the other end and cut it to three. And if we don't get anything out of that first trap, then we're going to foul right away. And that way only, 6 or 7 seconds go off the clock. You get a chance for a steal.
When you're down late in the game like this, you got to extend the game.
You do. I think there's enough time, though, to get a trap and a score.
We got Justin Sayers and Dustin Arnell in the game for defensive purposes here.
They get it across to Wolf, and he holds it there, and we're not coming out to get him. Wolf on the top of the key. Nobody's fouling. Nobody's trapping right now. Come on now. And then a foul by Sayers.
Fouled Remington, the 5'10 junior.
107, so 10 seconds went off the clock. No trap, just kind of fouled. Again, I think you can get the same thing if you trap once and foul. I don't think 10 seconds even runs off. But, again, game, time and score is something you work on and you work on and you work on. And they haven't just had a lot of time to work on it.
Yeah, the situational basketball.
I mean, that's not Coach Ader's fault. I mean, they haven't had a whole lot of time in the gym. That's a great teaching point for next game. First free throw's up and no good. Good.
He had side spin on that.
Yes, he did. Holden, 104 on the clock, driving, going in against pressure, kicks out for Mullins. Mullins for three, no good. Rebounded by Lowry. Lowry out to the three-point line, 55 seconds. Lowry, shake and bake, three-pointer. Two. Good!
That's a two.
Oh, they called it a two on the line.
His foot was on the line.
63-60.
One.
Got a foul, 44 seconds. Got a foul. Oh, he looks to steal it. Might be a 10-second call. Oh, Lowry deflects it, but it gets back to Wolf's hands. Now Howell's got it, and they foul him. Dyer fouls him with 35 seconds on the clock. And I think the scoreskeeper gave him 3 points, but I think the official said
and
it was two.
His foot was clearly on the line. No controversy there. As a two.
So 63-60, 35 seconds. Again, 20 seconds went off the clock before we fouled. But, that's just stuff you work on in practice.
Well, but it was a little different that time. We were being aggressive, and we had a chance at a couple steals.
Oh, we almost got it.
Yeah, we almost got a couple ones. So can't fault them there, because too many times I think guys just commit the foul and don't even go for the steal. And when you could, possibly, maybe a no call, mm-hmm. maybe, just a great play, bad reaction by the offense, get a steal.
Yes, and right now the clock says 34.5 seconds, 63-61, but really it's 63-60, and they're trying to fix the score.
So right now, too, next time on defense, we can, after that last free throw, hack a Remington.
That's right. And Howe, they're really good three-point shooter, so I'm imagining he's a good free throw shooter. But we're going to try to nix him, and we're going to go Newton. Let's see what happens. You ready? He dribbles, takes Newton, and he makes it. We tried.
Danny Lions are the devil.
64-60. Waverly up four, 34.5 seconds remaining in the contest. And Howe sets, shoots, and makes it. 65-60. Lowry gets the ball in bounds. 32 seconds. 30. 28. Lowry takes it off the crossover. Truett fakes and gets fouled shooting a three.
Great poise by J.J. Truett, the freshman.
Great job shot faking. 25.6 seconds. Now, I know the official didn't see it, but I did. His foot was on the line.
It was. Yes. It was. If this is the NBA, they look at that last minute of the game and see that a two-point foul shot. So, I saw the same thing.
And I think the officials really the second half have done a pretty good job, honestly. I mean, this has been a helter-skelter ball game the entire night. 65-60.
Yeah, but now we still don't have to like
Are they
them.
Talking about his foot being on the line?
Yep.
Do they get it right?
If they do, they got it right.
Let's see.
They're talking to Gray Shoes, Robertson.
Talking to Gray Shoes. And we're sitting over here talking, and they're saying, hey, so are you going to go, to Misty's Cone Shop after the game? Are you going to have some Demon's Chicken, or what are you going to do?
Yeah.
And Robertson argues that it was a three-pointer, or wasn't a three-pointer, and the official holds his ground, and that's because he's a Burke fan.
Thank you, Mr. Official.
Thank you. We appreciate you, and we will give you money later. First free throw's up and short.
Well,
25.6. 25.6. Second free throw's up and good.
Good. All right, Pirates got to start thinking time and score here.
And Justin Sayers coming in for Dyer to foul. 65-61. Good coach. Again, good game management by Coach Ader. You know, talking to the fellow on the bench saying, hey, this is what I need from you.
And I love subbing for the shooter because if you make it, it slows the game down right now, and Waverly can't push. So
and he made it.
It's like a mini timeout right
Absolutely.
Here.
Absolutely. 65-62.
Love that.
25.6. Darnell in the game now, looking to foul early. Full court pressure. They get
I'd let
Marquez, and he fouls. Good. We got the right guy.
Yeah, either one of those guys. I'd let him get it, foul him. Go for the steal, foul him.
65-62, 24.4, and Marquez is at the line shooting a 1-1.
Mean Gene says the ball don't lie. And
that's right.
He's right on
that. You know why the ball doesn't lie?
Because it's a ball.
Because it's a ball. So right now, Dyer and Truitt back in the game for offense. Pirates down three, 24.4. We got a 1-1 here. 1-1 by Marquez. He takes a deep breath. He shoots, and he makes it. I don't care if you made it or not. You fouled the right guy.
Yeah. Him or Remington right now, we got a foul.
66-62, 24.4. Second free throw. Up and no good.
Rebound Holden.
Holden down the timeline quickly, 20 seconds. Holden drives it, kicks it out to Truitt for three. Truitt gets it blocked partially. Dyer rebound, goes up, Shaw gets fouled.
And one, back Dyer.
Boom, shakalaka.
66-64. Dyer with the offensive rebound and the putback. 15.6 seconds.
Spinneruski.
That was a great offensive rebound. Goes up strong. Gets the foul and the bonus.
That's right. Pirates down two. Again, Coach Ader subbing in some guys to foul.
Right now, Pirates talking matchups, talking what they want to do here. Dustin Darnell ready to sub in for the shooter.
And you got to switch the screen here on the inbound. Don't let him get it in easy.
Switch everything.
Dyer with his and one free throw. It's up and good. 66-65.
We'll sub to slow it down.
Come on, face guard, fellas. Switch that screen. Hold on the ball.
Yep, I like that,
They're going deep.
Tanner's going to cause a distraction.
All right. They're back to cheerleaders up. It's even the cheerleaders are into the game. Wheelersburg's cheerleaders rocking and rolling. Taking the ball out of bounds. Looking to get the ball in bounds. Can't find it. Get it in Adrian. He kind of bobbles it. And they foul.
Tanner fouled him.
Oh, he almost dropped it. Great foul by Holden. 12.8 on
the clock. How many fouls is that on Tanner?
That is the fourth foul. Third foul.
So he hasn't picked up one since the first.
So 12.8. 66-65. Pirates are down one. Shout out to Mac Dyer for the rebound and the putback. That's called senior leadership. Thanks, Captain Woodward.
And that shout out's from Rare Fox.
And a shout out to Dave Ruck, Daddy Rucker. He says, let's go. First free throw. It's double bonus. Is up. And no good. Short. So that means get them in there and a rebound. Truitt, Dyer back in. It's going to come down to this. It's going to come down to this, Tommy Tebow.
12.8 seconds to go. The Pirates are going to have a shot to tie it or take the lead.
Right now we have one timeout left. We'll see what happens. I like playing through it. Second free throw is up and good.
Down two.
Tiger 67, Pirates 65. Probably going to inbound to Lowry. Lowry, and he calls Oh, good. Good timeout. Good timeout because it wasn't there. Coach Hayter, great timeout. 10.2 on the clock. 67-65. We cannot go away. I don't want to listen to music. I want to get focused. 10.2, Pirates down two.
So what are you saying in the huddle right now?
Honestly, I'm saying spread the floor and set a high ball screen for Holden or Lowry. Put your best shooters in the corner, and when they help, kick it out, bust the three, end the game, and I'm going to ride off in the sunset with Tommy Tebow.
I like Tanner driving with Lowry ready to catch on
the agree. Kick. Now, I think they're going to be tight on Lowry, tight on Holden.
I think
Connor Mullins. Yes, it's school night. We've got to go for three, Chad May says. I think right now Mullins and Truitt are going to hit. One of them is going to hit a game winner. All right, I'm going to call it now. One of them is going to hit a game winner in the corner.
Put it in the books.
I'm not even going to do the post game. I'm going to walk out to the car, and I'm just going to sit there and say, I told you.
And I'll clean up all the stuff.
And you clean up everything, and I'm getting coffee from.
Yeah, stop at Tim Hortons for me.
No, because they're not a sponsor. Well, actually, they are, Schmidt's Family Restaurant. All right, inbound to Dyer, then back to Truitt. Truitt driving, 8-7-6. He takes it all the way with the left. It gets blocked. Holden, Lowry gets the rebound, but it knocks out of bounds. 2.8. Balls underneath. I mean, what a great drive. He just didn't finish.
Yeah.
2.8. Pirates down two. No timeouts. No, timeout Robertson. I mean, that, the lane.
He was standing next to Coach Ader and called that timeout.
And I said Truett would hit the game winner, and I'm telling you, it was right there.
Yeah.
He did get it partially blocked, yep. I think. 2.8. Under OB. Down two. It's just really going to come down to a player making a play.
Yeah.
No play is going to make the difference. It's a player making a play.
I'm getting it to Cole Lowry, putting the ball in the hands of your senior, one of your top scorers, Cole. Game-winning three right here.
Hey, why not? Why not?
I think you can run Tanner off a screen, him
cutting it.
Yeah, going to the basket, that's going to draw a lot of attention, and you can pop out for three there.
Honestly, anytime the game is like this, there's two things you got to worry about as a defensive coach. One is the misdirection play. And right now would be a great time for Coach Ader to kind of draw up some kind of misdirection. Two is a tip-in. I know there's only 2.8, but if he gets it off quick and holding so long,
yeah.
I mean, a tip-in's there. Because
yep.
What's everybody do when the last second shot
watch.
Goes up? They watch. They're ball watchers.
Yep.
I can't wait.
I can't wait. Bart, brought to you by Bart Scott.
That's right. All right. 2.8, 67-65. What a great contest. What a great contest.
And you know Coach Ader pretty much had to draw this in the dirt because they haven't had the time to work on this play right here.
All right. Here's what we got. We got Holden isolated at the block. We got Lowry up top. We got Mullins and Dyer in the short corner in the corner.
They Truett double Holden.
It out. Truett looks to Holden. Holden catches, shoots a pull up, up and short.
No good. No good.
And that'll be your ball game. You know, you give it to your best player.
Yep.
It's good defense.
Good defense. I'm fine with Tanner with the ball in his hands.
That's right. I mean, you got to give Butter the ball. 67-65. Pirates are a loser tonight, but honestly, what a great comeback. And we will be back to talk about our post-game show. Listen to a little music, get a little Gatorade, or high-quality H2O, and we'll be back with a little bit of information.
All right, Pirate fans, we have the end of the game, Dave Watts post-game show, because just like Coach Watts, the end is near, brought to you by Misty's Cone Shop. Get you a footer. So right now we have Dusty the Truth Sayers, who's going to give us the stats from the night. Dusty, go ahead.
All right, here we go. Final stats, Tanner Holden, he led us in scoring. He had 16 points, and he also had 13 rebounds. Another double-double for Tanner to go along with four assists and one steal. Cole Lowry, he finished with 15 points, six rebounds, three assists, and two steals. J.J. Truett had a big fourth quarter. He finished with 15 points, one rebound, and one steal. Connor Mullins finished with 8 points, two rebounds, two steals. Mac Dyer, 6 points, six rebounds, and one steal. Justin Salyers, 2 points and two rebounds. And Dustin Darnell with 3 points and one assist.
All right. All right. Thank you, Dusty. Now let's get a game recap and reflective thoughts and game analysis from the coach, Boston Brents.
All right. So basically we talked about our keys to the game being kind of we got to take care of the basketball. And one of the things that we did in the second half, which is why we made, you know, such a ferocious comeback in the fourth quarter, was basically we had 10 turnovers at halftime, but we only ended with 14 turnovers. So only four turnovers in the second half, did a much better job of taking care of the basketball. We did talk about having three guys in double figures, and we did. We had, you know, Truitt had 15 and Holden 16 and Lowry 15 and Mullins had 8. And how about Dyer with the big three-point play there at the end? I mean, so a lot of things we did really, really well in terms of our keys to the game. But a couple things that definitely were kind of a glaring weakness for us tonight was our basically on-the-ball containment.
Yes.
You know, we just did not contain the basketball as well as we needed to. And then the one segment there where Howe hit two threes with kind of hand man down, or, you know, hand down, man down kind of philosophy. You know, those little possessions, you know, and anybody that coaches will tell you, those small possessions will be a difference maker.
And it's normally, we always say, 4 to 5 possessions a ball game.
Absolutely.
It's going to make the difference.
Especially against two really, really good teams. I mean, that moves Waverly to 6-1. They're 4-1 in the SOC. You know, the biggest thing looking forward is, you know, we showed a lot of grit, a lot of toughness. We were down 44-30. You know, we cut it to 2 with the ball with, 11 seconds or so to go. So, you know, we had a chance to win or tie. Just the last second shot just did not go in the game, you know, in the bucket. But so far, you know, I like what I see out of this team. I really do. I think, you know, when we put a couple sets in, you know, and have time to put a couple sets in, and I don't know that time's really going to come this week since we play Friday, Saturday against West and then against Portsmouth on Saturday. But when we have a little bit of time to kind of put some plays in place for those kind of situations, I think we'll be just fine. I think we'll be fine when we play the Tigers at home. I really do. I honestly, one of my biggest things that I thought our coaching staff, Coach Hader, did a good job. I thought our game management in the fourth quarter was really, really good. You know, for not only having 9 or 10 practices, we extended the game, like you said, and pushed it out and fouled the right people, subbed at the right times, hit some key shots. I mean, you know, that's all you can ask for as a coach, to have a chance to win against a good team at the end, and we had that chance.
Yeah, and I think, you know, I agree with all the things you said game-wise, and a lot of the things you said are going to lead to what I'm going to say, and it's easy to say, but one thing we got to do is the second half, coming out of that second half, the big run has got us. The big run got us against Northwest and brought them back into the ball game, and the big run got Waverly ahead to where we couldn't surmount a comeback there. So we got to try to limit that run. Both third quarters.
Because I think against Northwest we were up 17 at half, and then we kind of dwindled that. And then this team, we're down 3 at half, but then we went down 14.
Yeah, 11-0 run there.
Right. So, you know, let's look at the Bill Mays game prediction brought to you by Ridge Mini Mart, Scott May, J.D. Emnett. So, TK, your prediction was 74-73. All right. Bill Mays was 50-30.
I think he was wrong.
Yes, and mine was 63-59. Based on that.
And Rucker Daddy was 107 to Waverly 1.9. Waverly scored a little bit more than 1.9 points.
They did. They did. I mean, so basically I had 122 points total. There was 132 in the game. You had 147. So I'm going to go with Boston Brent on that prediction. I was a little closer, but, you know, you were a little closer in the margin, so maybe it's just a 1-1 tie. You know, Ruck Daddy player of the game.
I don't like ties.
Yeah, I don't either. So, Ruck Daddy player of the game. Who are you giving it to?
Ruck Daddy player of the game. I got to go with Tanner Holden again. I mean, he led us in points and rebounds, and he was our guy, and he's going to be our guy all year. We're going to ride with Tanner, and he's going to take us some big places, I believe. But right now, we got to work out the kinks and work on all the keys like you talked about. But I got to go with Tanner.
And you know, he hasn't shot a 3. In 2 games.
You know, I about said that during the game. I noticed that too. And he's not looking for that shot. He's looking for to drive because he knows they're going to give him a lot of help and he can kick and find shooters.
And my player of the game, and those folks listening probably knows, J.J. Truitt. 15 big points. Had a really, really, really good fourth quarter. He took 3 charges.
I heard you love charges.
I love it. I mean, he took 3 charges, sacrificed his body, caused turnovers. I mean, and also got 3 fouls on the other team. It's a win-win-win. So, J.J. Truitt is my player, Ruck Daddy player of the game. Tanner Holden is Tommy Tebow's. If you go to Deemer's, you can get your chicken dinner. And remember, buy local, eat the chicken, greasy.
I think by now, when Tanner Holden walks into Deemer's, he don't have to ask. They just hand him a chicken dinner.
They just hand him a big, old pot of chicken.
Actually, I think they hand him a live chicken.
All right. You're a live chicken. It's like, what's that singer? I can't even remember his name.
That one singer
that
guy?
That one guy with the hair. Right.
Yes.
All right, so our thoughts moving forward, Coach Caskey. We've got West, who's a really good team. I mean, you know, came and played this Tiger team tough. Just lost in overtime to Webster at Webster. So, you know, you got Waverly, you know, West up Friday, Portsmouth up Saturday. Two game, you know, basically two, three practices in between. Excuse me, Wednesday, Thursday. So two practices in between. Not a whole lot of time again.
Yeah.
So, you know, basically, to me, it's like get your legs back.
Right.
And go play, really.
And that's going to be tough tomorrow because, I mean, they're not going to have any legs tomorrow in practice. So you really got to manage that, and they will. That Friday game against West is our home opener. Now, Bird Fan will not be covering that game. So make sure you get out to the home opener, support the Pirates, give them the home court advantage that we can have to take down the West Side.
And then Saturday is against Portsmouth at home, and we will be doing that. Because we don't want Trojan Fan to take advantage of us. But on the slate before that is what, Tommy Tebow?
Thursday, big home game for the girls' basketball team. They take on South Webster. The JV will start at 6, and I didn't get –
They'll only play two quarters. Only two quarters on Thursday night for the JV game. Oh, actually, excuse me. Four quarters for the JV game. Coach Spradlin says.
So we'll look to be on around 7 o'clock-ish. We'll keep you posted on Facebook, any changes to the schedule, and when we look to go on air. So pay attention to Facebook and Twitter there.
I'm also going to say this, that our JV team won tonight. They won, and they're 2-0 now, so good. And then also Thursday, because I got, you know, I'm middle school AD, I got to do it.
Not to brag.
Right, but South Webster plays the girls at home. That should be a really good contest, actually. South Webster 7th and 8th grade teams are very good. That's the girls' game at home. And then the boys, another two really good teams for South Webster, and we've got some really good teams as well. We play on the road. The boys play on the road, junior high, and our junior high teams have been very successful this season thus far.
So what you could do, I'm going to plan out your Thursday for you. You can go to the middle school gym, 5:30 p.m., catch some of the junior high girls at home. That 7th grade group is a very good group, an exciting group to watch.
Absolutely. They're undefeated right now.
They're undefeated.
Coached by Derek Moore and our 8th grade coach by Chris Skyver.
And they're doing a great job with those girls. So you can catch some of the junior high, watch them 7th and a little in the 8th grade, and then come over and catch the JV game, the end of the JV game for the girls basketball that leads us into the varsity game that will be live on Berg Fan.
Absolutely. All right. We're going to take a short break, and then we're going to come back and wrap it up.
You are dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping in the nosebleeds.
All right, and we're back for the final time here, guys. Waverly 67, Wheelersburg 65. Waverly goes 6-1, and the Pirates go 1-1. You know, just a couple things. I think our basketball team this year is going to be fantastic. I really do. I mean, you can see their legs are dying out a little bit in the third. But I'm telling you, this Pirate basketball team, come tournament time, is going to be legit. And tell me a little bit, you know, what are your kind of – I mean, I look at this, and this is something nobody's talking about. But Trent Salyer's obviously coming off a great football season and broke his leg, his fibula. But I'm telling you right now, Mullins and Darnell – and Justin Salyer's, I mean, those three are getting minutes because he is hurt. And you know, we've had foul trouble tonight, and those kids had key minutes tonight and made key contributions. What's your thoughts about that?
Well, I think you're going to look back during the tournament in March, and you're going to look back on this and say that was invaluable time for them to be put in those situations and to get better. Because, I mean, yes, you're going to get better in practice, but when you get thrown to the fire, and some of those guys, this is the first time they've been thrown to the fire. They haven't had to play in pressure-packed games like that. So this is only going to make those players better and the team better down the road.
All right, so again, let's just thank our sponsors one more time, and then we'll get off here. Deemer's Market, the C-Store, Cottle Trailer Sales, Glockner's, Schmidt's Family Restaurant, Dempsey Heating and Air, Ridge Mini Mart, Misty Cone Shop, Johnson's Shirt Stop. And again, thank you to Mr. Bonar Arnett from Waverly, the athletic director, for hosting us tonight. Boston Brent.
Boston Brent.
Have a job.
Have a job.
And Tommy.
Have a job.
Tebow. Fat right. Sheila Tebow.
Good night, Burke Man.